think that.
I linked him in Brendan's anime chat.
Also, please don't actually look at the stream window because you might accidentally get spoiled.
One time I looked at my viewer list and I saw Malcolm in my stream and I was just like third eye emoji.
I wasn't, I didn't have banished.
I just have specific notes.
Malcolm is over.
Yeah, I'm over. It's done.
Yo. All
right.
I'm gonna put a fan cam under the tweet. Like,
this is mostly.
I'm like barely lucid.
All
right. Yeah, fun. Barely lucid roleplay.
Barely lucid roleplay can promote the best roleplay.
Okay. Dude, jet lag has mad hands.
Jet lag got hands. Like, I'm not even kidding. I've been jet lagged from, like, flights to, like, the West Coast and East Coast. I can't imagine.
Yeah.
I simply cannot imagine.
It's kind of like someone puts your sleep schedule into a blender and you just figure it out.
Yeah. Well, a good thing. We have one more, what's it called? We have one more moonbeam. Mm-hmm. Yay, one more moonbeam. Yay, woo.
Yeah, woo.
and I still have both of my spell slots. Both of which to be maximized inflict wounds.
And I have as many uses of my for long rest, my proficiency bonus of my wildfire spirit, which is a whole two, and I've used them once today. So the plan is simple, guys.
I'm going ghost.
I took guidance, that's why. I don't need
this guy's gonna open his door and he's gonna see
yeah.
death himself. No.
I just his door, see three torch. Scorching rays at him.
Do you think that he's gonna have the opportunity to open his door as my wildfire spirit is materializing? No, it's not open. We saw him through the window.
Oh, we saw him through the window.
Spirit is materializing right now in front of him and fiery teleporting him outside into my prepped burning hands.
I'm just going to mention that, like, I thought, oh, man, I'll explain after this session, but I have been leading up to what is about to happen here.
I can't wait to take shape water when I get, like, a fourth cantrip and it actually be, I transmute it.
just have him be...
This arc to be super depressing.
Just have him like face the thing, like face the wildfire spirit, so it looks like, so he thinks that he's gone to hell.
Wait, roll. Time.
No, it's like my wildfire spirit. My wildfire spirit's flavored. Like it looks. It's supposed to look like bots as like a thing, and it's
Wait, magical swords and secrets.
Like that's how I was thinking of it, and yeah, it's just like it's like a. You know those fire things in Skyrim, like the trees that are on fire.
Yep.
That's what I had in my head for it, like the elemental trees. You know the ones.
I'm gonna go grab a drink.
Yeah, feel free. We are still waiting on Tyler, who I hope is here soon.
Yeah, hit his line.
Tyler, I'm gonna add him. Fuck.
Is at level 4 our proficiency bonus is still +2? Yeah.
Yes, +5 is when it changes.
Yeah. Level 5 is when it changes.
That's what I figured. I'm excited for the Vinay one shot where I finally get to play my Tiefling Barb idea.
Yeah,
I finally get to play.
I still need to give. Yeah, I still need to give feedback.
Ooh, he's not a good online right now.
I was actually gonna switch to Zola, but then Park said that he's gonna play a rogue, and I was like, oh man.
Listen, I'm going to make
Park Rogue. I literally named it Paro.
Paro.
Paro,
which is short really? For Parogi.
Yes,
it's short for Park Rogue because I'm very smart.
Hey, listen. How can I say anything? My first character's name was Mason.
Yeah, I've at least never done. I've never done a car or something.
I couldn't think of anything. I was like, what guys, the fuck?
Do I order Chipotle?
Self-insert at this point.
Yeah, Mason's like barely a self-insert. It was just the name. I couldn't think of anything.
Yeah, and then I always just pictured you.
I know, right?
Names are powerful.
I know. I'm trying to think.
It was just Luffy in my head, man.
Same.
Like,
same.
Cause, like, that was the token.
Yes.
Okay, okay. So I need to...
That Luffy.
Oh, yeah. There's been many Luffy's over. Levitate and Earth and Grass. Because those aren't on my list. Yeah. Levitate. Right. Dude, I'm so excited to levitate. I float 20 feet up in the air.
I can't wait for Tommy to let me produce flame so much that I can fly.
Yes.
No, that's
going to be pretty epic, actually.
That's
when that eventually happens.
That's awesome. That
friggin'
just not how it works. Yeah, that's how you can probably flavor, you know,
you
the
can
spell
flavor
fly.
You can flavor.
Yeah, but he doesn't get that.
Druids don't get fly, man.
They don't get fly?
No, that's a wizard. That's an arcane spell.
You get investiture of wind eventually.
When's investiture of wind?
Sixth level. Oh,
fifth level?
My bad.
It's six, yes, because it's a warlock arcanum or whatever.
Oh wait, yeah, that's how I'll do investiture of wind then.
Let's see, is anyone in the chat? We got the spicy one viewer here.
Yo.
This is honestly recording this is mostly for my own reference.
I look back on my VODs a lot.
Okay.
I wish I could look back on my VODs. Instead, the only thing I have is Vinay's character's journal.
Why do some of my Wildmount VODs get like 20 views and I don't know where they come from? Part 11.
It's us trying to remember what happened last session.
Yeah.
I don't think any of you actually do that.
Oh no,
I do. I take notes.
No, we take notes. It's just to update my.
Oh wait, I gotta highlight. I gotta highlight the last two parts so they don't get yeeted into Twitch oblivion.
Control right, wins. I could also do.
Lads, I have Chipotle on the way.
Yo, pog.
Oh wait, someone subscribed. Wow.
What?
Oh, thanks for subscribing, Harrison.
Wow. Oh, Harrison. Wow. He's never subscribed to me.
Harrison, I promise. Harrison, I will play Bloodborne at some point. I promise.
He'll unsubscribe if you don't play Bloodborne.
I need to figure out a setup for my PS4. Mm. I'll get on that this week.
I rel car you.
It's been.
He is a nice boy with a dream.
He's not even online right now.
God damn it.
He's a nice boy with a dream.
Is
he creepy. Wants to find a flower and heal his land.
I'm going ghost.
Arel. I wrote it down as IREL, but AYREL.
AYREL.
Totally sounds like Arel in my head.
Question. I mean, yeah. What is everyone's okay, let me just look at everyone's
AC.
Yeah, everyone's AC.
Yeah, what's everyone's constitution modifier?
Yeah.
I have 13, Tommy.
You're 13.
I think I have 17.
I'm refusing to take mage armor out of principle.
I have 17.
I have 16.
15.
I just don't want to take mage
armor. How do I have the highest AC of anyone?
My AC is 19.
Wait, what do you have?
Vinay, you said 16 at first.
No. My con is 16. My ace is splint mail plus a shield.
Okay. Malcolm, I was gonna say, I was like, how's the druid at the highest AC?
No.
Marius, 43 health.
Okay. Shit. Okay. Thank you, Mason. Let's see.
How do I pop out a Twitch chat? I just want to have the chat
open. Slightly out of anyone.
Actually, I'm just gonna open it. I'm just gonna open the stream in a new window, but only have the chat.
You should only have the chat you're gonna get spoiled otherwise. So, where is Tyler? I asked if this was I've literally been good about making sure it works for everyone.
Hammer's DMs.
Tommy just doesn't want to spam him.
I don't want to spam him, but I'm gonna like.
I'm gonna spam him.
Spam him. Let's all ping him.
People love that.
Do we want to just start if he's not here by 8:30?
I think that's fair.
Yeah.
Do I?
Because he can just join in after we can fill it in and just like pretend.
Oh
that,
wait.
Like...
I'm in normal times.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're normal times. Welcome. Isn't that crazy?
Not normal times. Eastern Standard Time. Come on. Everyone's time is normal where they are.
Well, he called it normal time first.
It's normal time relative to the majority.
Right. Relative to the boys.
The boys, yeah. Because I was off in some outlier time.
Oh, so. Man. It's going to be so funny when Ben's girlfriend's named Erica, right?
Yes.
Yes.
It's... Oh, wait, that means I inadvertently named an NPC after her. That's kind of
cool. No, dude, that's such a common name.
I mean, the thing is worse. Yeah. I mean, the thing is worst case that I do have his character sheet.
You have his character sheet, and like worst comes to worst, like
I could just play as him until.
Do you know if he, Tommy? Do you know if he leveled up?
I'm looking if he leveled up.
My
moonsicle. He is not leveled up in his sheets.
Okay.
So,
three.
Worst comes to worst, he's just hanging back.
I can't wait till Erica watches.
No, that's gonna be such a disaster.
Great.
We're gonna like try to set Derek up with someone. Or
no,
something.
No, she
like,
knows
something
she,
really
she,
dumb
she,
is gonna happen.
She knows I'm Ben's meme dealer. She knows the deal. she knows the deal.
Is everyone in? By the way.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. I am going to show you the map.
Went the Erica right. One shot.
Oh my god.
You can't see.
Yeah, it's fog of war. Wait, right. Monopoly men. Who are the Monopoly men?
That's the mayor.
The mayor.
Yeah, that's
the mayor. Okay.
Mayor Knickerbockers.
Nick with them.
Yeah, Knickerbockers. I remember that. I wrote that down.
Wow.
Who's this fellow? Oh wait, that's the guy we have.
Yeah, I was in front.
Okay, so the wildfire spirit is approximately.
Hold on.
Oh, wait, I can. I can put things into him. I didn't know that.
Wait, it doesn't
take a spot.
Oh, the character means.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's only SRD.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah, so you would have to put some stuff in.
Okay, but no, but that will work, so I don't have to always have to look it up. So that's where the spirit is right now, Tommy.
Got it.
The spirit is in front of his ass, is apparating in front of him right now.
Okay.
Is this your
reaction? Yeah. Behind him, himself in front of him.
I will give him until 8:30. Otherwise, I have. I'm trying to think here.
We just gotta keep it rolling, you know.
Yeah, boys.
Like, yeah.
Come on, where is? Yeah, I go until 8:30.
His rogue is stealthing.
Just stealthing.
Yeah.
Worst case,
I mean,
I'll say that.
Worst case, this is like street combat or whatever. I don't know.
Chipotle is taking way too long to process my order. I don't like this.
Taking way too long to process my orders lately? Showdown.
What?
Dude, Showdown's been not shitting the bed for me lately.
Yeah, Luke also said he didn't notice anything, but it's been bad for me and a few other people.
It just does that sometimes, like some messed up stuff with your DNS. I had to deal with it for a while, where my account got linked to someone else's.
Oh, how did that happen?
Who put in Luffy One Piece?
What?
I was waiting for it.
Wait, what happened?
Yeah, it was me.
I don't see him.
All right, so.
No. It's in the shared lore doc.
Yeah.
Wait, I liked how someone wrote Lich King Pog, which I assume is Ben.
Okay.
Probably. Yeah, it's Ben.
Almost certainly Ben.
Yo, is that Ben in the chat? Yeah, it's. No, it's not.
We're talking about the shared lore doc.
Oh,
yeah.
Got it. I'm waiting for.
Where's
stuff
where's
I don't want to spoil that involves some shared lore, which is unfortunate.
Also, we need to decide on the name.
I'm
okay with
guys. Do Exandria.
Question. how do you show shit to people again?
Shift-Z.
Shift-Z.
Are we starting?
Not yet.
My food is on the way.
This is Lin.
Bringing it to you right now.
This is Lin, the changeling you have captured, except his right eye is, not there.
Isn't Pari holding him, if I'm remembering correctly?
Yes. I am, in fact, holding him.
Yeah.
So, he should be, like,
So put him, like, right here. Yeah.
Yeah.
Jor-El's got the anime eyes right now.
Also,
my hand is right next to my holy symbol.
Alright, I think...
The smiley face?
I want to start this so badly.
No, that's not the holy symbol.
I
just do it.
Do you guys really just want to start right now?
Yeah, he can just drop. He can just hop in.
He can drop in. We fill him in. You know.
Yeah.
Okay. So
it happens. Life happens. All that. You know.
All right. Okay. I designed this fight for 5 people, but worst case,
it'll be fine. I have twin meta magic.
It's fine. I have all my spells.
Yeah, we have all of our stuff.
Okay. I don't.
I am.
Irel does not. But
just a fair
he
warning.
He has one moonbeam.
I have a moonbeam.
Just a fair warning. This might be a tad difficult in that case.
That's fine.
All
right, that's okay. Rebalance it on the fly too. If worse comes to worse.
If we die, we die. It's fine.
I just figured I'm just warning you guys.
I don't think
okay,
that's fine.
Breach positions.
I don't think that's fine. I don't think if we die, we die.
So by the way, I've already gone ghost.
Also, while I am last minute preparing stuff, does anyone want to give a recap?
We infiltrated this house of the senator. And we did a bunch of shenanigans to avoid actually fighting anything. And then we found the fake senator who was a changeling. And then Jarell was like, what am I? And stuff. And then me and Irel found the body of the dead actual senator. And the mayor was tied up.
Mayor Knickerbockers.
Why is that his name? I can't take that seriously.
Because it's his name. He looks like a Monopoly Man.
Is that the canon Monopoly Man nickname?
No, I just made it up because it sounded like Monopoly Man.
Okay, we got this in the bag. Did anyone else remember? If there's anything else?
Not particularly. We came.
So the fake mayor was talking to the mayor's wife.
Yeah.
Just give me one second. I need to.
Malcolm.
I need to get
Malcolm. Do you not have a Roll 20 profile picture, or is it just like broken?
It's just not loading.
There's one thing I forgot.
It never shows up for me, so it always just shows like an invisible square.
Mine is my WordPress logo from like 2012. Paul Pierce hasn't been on the Celtics since 2013.
Okay, all right.
Good job,
so
staying up to date.
All right, you guys remember?
I love Paul Pierce. Though.
All right, so
I'm totally not going to be able to levitate in here. There's no way. There's 20 foot high ceilings.
All right.
Wait, I have a new trick.
I'm also gonna eat while I'm doing this because I didn't finish my food. So.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, I'm just floating outside the door right now.
Yep, yep. Okay. The wildfire spirit is in the middle of a fiery teleportation. It is going to appear right hither.
All right, so
before combat even starts, it's
procced. Yes, it's on. It's on. Right, like the fiery teleportation's procced.
All right, I can't wait for you guys to shit yourselves when you see what's in for you.
No, we're not going to be the ones shitting our pants.
No. Are you sure?
Well, no, yes. Tommy's
trying to TPK us. Well,
no, it's not for that reason. It's something else.
My character exists to make it.
All right, so I guess let's begin.
Also, if it's balanced to 5 people, you can just play the rogue like you would play a rogue if it's designed for 5 people.
I
think that's the best case.
Remember what happened last time Tommy played a rogue?
Actually, I actually had a backup plan.
I'm inside the house. I'm in, guys.
Okay. Oh, yeah, Malcolm, you can't see anything that's inside the house, right? Okay. So
I'm in.
All right. So what happens is roll initiative. Everyone.
How are we rolling initiative before the spirit teleports that? I've had that procced for 2 weeks.
Oh no, that's fine. I'm saying roll initiative anyways.
What did I roll? I accidentally left the roll 20.
You rolled a 3.
Oh, you rolled a 3.
That's
Let's go, Mason.
7 temporary hit points.
Dang it, my twinning of enlarge reduce will have to wait until the end of initiative.
Give me one second.
Double checking my decks.
That's such a bummer. I really rolled a nat 1 and 19. Then Mason rolled a nat 20.
Oh, our initiatives are good.
Except for me.
Except for you.
Listen, that's when you haste us at the start of round 2.
I don't have haste yet. I'm level 4.
That's when you enlarge the wildfire druid. Or no, you enlarge Pari.
No. Enlarge the ghost.
Yeah, enlarge the spooky ghost.
Or both. So we can
point to their gravestone. It says Ebenezer Scrooge.
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
I am the ghost of Christmas yet to come.
All right.
Chipotle is 18 minutes away.
Wow, I can't believe Primal Savagery's prepped and procked and ready for the sky.
Primal Savagery, that's kind of an odd, that's kind of a bad name.
I also had to roll because I was doing homework assignment up until the session, so. Okay,
I wonder if he's going to look on Discord.
Please tell me.
What, Malcolm?
Oh, wow.
Did I just hear you whispering something?
Nothing.
What the fuck? Oh, shit. Alright, I rolled both well and shit. It was a mix.
Yeah, right. Just like us.
Yes. Yay. All right.
Wait, Malcolm,
so,
what was your initiative?
Okay.
19.
It's
literally just me at the end.
Okay, everyone, tell me your initiatives, preferably in order, as I write them down.
22.
Okay.
21.
19.
3.
Wow.
Stop. Who chuckled?
That was me.
Not me.
Be like Knuckles, don't chuckle.
Okay, so, yeah, we waited long enough, everything is all set. We have to get the show on the road.
Yes.
Hopefully Tyler gets here soon. He gets here when he gets here. But, first thing you do, because you've had it prep for 2 weeks. So, we last left off. This Mayor Knickerbockers... First thing he
real
does.
One.
So this one comes out the door. And he says, "Hello." He tries to say, "Oh, who are you people?"
And before, as he's saying that, my wildfire spirit has already grabbing him, and they've been whooped right here where my hand is in front of them, with burning hands prepped.
And also, the first thing he sees when he opens the door is my form of dread, so he has to make a DC 15 wisdom save.
Also, Lynn needs to be next to Pari, because Pari has been restraining him the whole time.
Yes. Okay. Yep. So, he succeeded. He succeeded on the wisdom saving throw, Malcolm.
Okay.
I don't think pinging him will work if he doesn't check Discord, Mason.
No, I just want this one last hang.
Yeah, let's just check
for the road.
Also,
for the road.
I should mention, you are at the front of the door now, and you can see what is inside.
Oh
yes, what is inside?
The first thing you see.
It's gonna be like a killer clown house.
Is copies of yourself.
What?
Oh. Okay.
That's not very good. That's why he was asking for our ACs.
Well, I mean, he's outside.
And then, so, the first thing you hear is, in a voice eerily similar to Iroh, he says, "Hey, what are you doing to the mayor?"
Oh, that's creepy.
But then Iroh, can Iroh hear this?
Yes. You hear the voice. You don't see it, but you hear the voice.
Iroh. His eyes are on fire. His eyes are like actual Iroh's eyes are like completely on fire. And his voice sounds like a raging forest fire. And he's just like, "Come out." He's saying, "Come the fuck out," as the spirits transported the mayor. The spirit and the mayor is outside.
Oh, should he respond? Tyler's going to be here soon. Okay, good.
All right,
Okay.
I am so sorry, everybody. I very much lost track.
Okay, so it's fine. So Teenie, who was off hiding somewhere, comes out of the bushes.
Incredible.
So Iroh's just like, and he's saying, is just like, if you're wearing my face, he's just like, he's like, you can die with my face or yours, you pick. And it sounds like a raging forest fire.
And he says,
can I insight check to see if they're also changelings?
Insight, yeah, do an insight check.
And because I am a changeling, can I have advantage on that?
I would say that straight roll. And there's a reason for that, trust me.
But we know that they're all changing.
So you look closely and you can tell there are you can deduce that there are some changelings, but also something else that's not quite a changeling.
So they're all changelings.
No. They're not all changelings.
Okay.
Out.
And because you rolled a natural 20, I will say that the two that are different and that you probably would deduce are not changelings would be the ones mimicking Perry and Iroh.
Oh, boy.
All right.
Iroh's going to murder
Iroh.
I
should also mention that also, Tyler, put yourself on the map when you get the chance. Okay, so... Also, I should mention, as Jarell peers in, the room is pretty well lit. And you also see this. You also see... Oh, and I just need to make sure I'm not accidentally revealing something I shouldn't be revealing. Mm-hmm. You guys also see Jafar Brutus, and someone else.
And a very evil man.
Yes.
Hmm.
Oh, boy. I'm going to zoom in and see if it's a Fire Emblem character.
No,
it looks like it.
Oh, wait, where are they?
Shift-Z.
Oh.
But it's a very evil man.
Wait, are there two of Jafar and Brutus?
Yes.
Oh, that's going to be annoying.
And you don't know who is who yet.
Well, the mayor is outside.
So
right now. The mayor is in Iroh's hands. Like, actually. Like, his face. Like, he's grabbing him, like, by, like, the neck with the burning hands procced. He's hearing the brunt of the forest fire yelling. And he's basically saying, he's just like beside himself. He's just like, you can knock this shit off.
You have access to hot water?
You get to live.
Yes.
Wait, really? This is hot the entire time.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Sorry. Please.
Forms.
So, you see a Jor-El. Or the other Jor-El, and he says, I'm going to ask you to drop your form.
My ass, I will.
Why isn't the mayor outside in Iroh's hands?
I can move him. Very sure. Sorry, I meant to, but I was on something else. So, at this point, he is there. And please, roll. You said you procced Burning Hands. Please roll for damage on
no,
that.
No, 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 it is procced. If he does anything,
it's ready.
Okay.
It's ready.
Got it.
It's
got
ready.
It.
Like my hand, my like one hand is like on his like face, like grabbing it, like you know when someone grabs someone by like the scruff of their neck. That's what Iroh's doing to fake Mayor Knickerbockers.
And then, so the first thing he says is,
"You can be a bit sensible about this." I'm unarmed.
Iroh is looking with his eyes.
Changeling with that natural 20?
Yes.
Iroh's eyes burning. Iroh, he has set the urn down. He's just like, I cremated another man tonight.
What you hold in your hand is also a changeling. So there is no confusion.
Oh, I am well aware.
He kind of
and
said,
it's like
oh,
sounding
boy.
Like the forest fire shit. He's just like, you choose. Die with your real face or die with this one.
Alright, so you see he says, alright, I'll just give me a minute, I'll change out of this one.
No, Iroh still is holding him.
You can...
That would be the mayor's action, by the way.
Yes, I should mention he can't do it. Yeah, he said he's not doing it at the moment. I should mention that he is, you can also, Iroh can clearly see that he is unarmed.
He's unarmed? Oh, yes. Iroh is just like, he's beside himself,
oh,
angry. And the fact that someone is changing, is imitating him.
Yeah,
is like making him like
get rid of this because it's pretty obvious.
Why are they like us?
I don't know.
I'm gonna kick him in the knee.
I'm gonna say
he does like one damage, so it's fine.
It's not your turn though. I'm gonna say. Okay.
But no, we're not even in combat yet.
No, wait. I was gonna. Okay, yeah. This is like right before combat, before the shit goes down. I will allow the hit. Or
yeah, I'm just gonna kick his knee out.
Roll the hit. Unarmed strike.
I'm gonna miss. Let's see actions. Unarmed strike plus 3. Yeah, this is gonna hit.
Let's. Yeah, that does hit. His AC kind of sucks. So,
oh, okay. I just kick him for 2.
You kick him in the knee and he goes, ah!
He just like, if he's like in eye roll, like during that ah or whatever, he's just like, if we're going to be sensible, everyone in there drop their forms right now.
So the first thing you hear from the guy who is impersonating you, he says,
We're down here. We're not in the house yet.
Or you hear a voice like when he. Basically, you all can't see him yet, but mm-hmm. But based on what Jor-El can see, he kind of relays the information back to you. You can hear the voice. It's pretty obvious. And he says, Touché. I'm asking you all to drop the forms. We just came here to protect the mayor, and you guys are...
So Irel is... I'm not going to actually scream.
You can't fool one of your own kind.
And then Irel is going to scream. Like, I'm not actually going to scream, but Irel is going to scream, how many more people are going to die because of your fucking bullshit? This is unconscionable. You're irredeemable garbage.
I don't know what you're talking about.
And then Irel...
You don't.
Shit, I just cremated a man tonight.
And also, I should mention, at this point, if you want to do any more actions, you are in combat.
So, Irel is going to fiery teleport in. Right here.
Wait, don't...
Didn't you already use the fiery teleport?
Yeah.
That was before combat.
Oh.
I will allow it, because he did
explicitly... Wait, Irel, don't go in without us.
I should mention that the only one who actually sees what's inside at this point is Jor-El, because he's okay. Yeah, he's kind of.
I'm not gonna let Pari fuck him up.
Mason, you put your spirit on my token.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'll say that you backed up before combat. So
also, just because they're in my form doesn't mean that they get their my abilities.
I know.
I find that for changelings.
No, I know. I have my own shit for them. Don't worry.
Probably doppelgangers.
So,
I did explain that some are changelings, others you don't know what they are.
So, my spirit is teleporting in the air, right?
Yes.
Here? Mm-hmm. With me, as soon as I'm in, I'm firing off an upcast, I'm just firing off a regular Burning Hands.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so combat's non.
Yeah, as he's doing that, I turn to, I'm sorry, what's the rogue's name?
The rogue's name...
Teeny.
Okay. I turn to Teeny and Lockhart, and I point to the fake Mario, and I say,
apprehend him!
Well, we gotta help him in the house first. I'll just charge him.
So everyone's caught in this Burning Hands.
Literally everyone, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that is 4 DC 16 dex saves.
All right. It's time to roll. I am just making sure that I have their stat blocks right, which is true. One of them rolled a nat 1.
Beautiful.
Fail.
Good.
Incredible.
Fail.
Yo.
And Wow, they all failed.
Yo, beautiful. Let's go.
Beautiful. So they're taking 8 fire damage.
Everyone's taking 8?
Everyone's taking 8.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So as you go...
And so the deck save was above. So the teleport was above them, so I can't do anything else with the spirit.
I should mention that... it's just those 4. I should mention... Yes, so you go inside, and you catch them off guard, and they are kind of taken aback by the flames in your eyes, and you burning hands them.
Yeah, and it's like he's throwing a punch and when he lands, it's like he's throwing a punch for the burning hands, and it's like erupting out of it.
Ace, is that you?
Yes, it is. It is.
It is just Ace One Piece.
So, you do that, and do you want to do anything else with your action?
I got nothing else.
All right.
Let's go party.
Okay. So, next is going to be, let me just double check the ACs. Pari, AKA Vinay, mm-hmm. I need you to, what's your dex modifier?
+2.
Okay. So you're going, after Zelroth or after the mysterious man.
Okay, cool. We know his name now.
Fuck.
Okay. Should I have to roll initiative?
Well, sorry, please roll initiative, Tyler. Oh, wow.
He goes, so he actually goes next. So he I already right went.
Now. We're gonna say that he goes next, right, but now. From now on, he goes at the start of the order. Okay, what do you want to do, Tyler?
First, I'm gonna go up to... Sorry, Malcolm. What was your character's name?
Jor-El.
I'm gonna say you can't tell me what to do, and then proceed to apprehend said mayors.
So you're apprehending both mayors?
That is a strange course of events.
He's just keeping an eye on both of them. One's the good mayor, and then we already know this one's a changeling. So.
I was told to apprehend, so I'm doing that.
If they choose to run. And you can do as you wish.
You see the good mayor, and he just kind of goes like, "But I feel like it's
you can
not...
leave him. You I, can leave him. He's leave fine.
I just right,
cool.
came.
I got like... my eye on. I got my eye on.
Yeah. Yeah. So the guy who you would dub as the good
one,
mayor,
the one with, we just got, the one with the smoldering the arm one... because he just got fiery teleported.
The one who I should mention, the good mayor, is he's still kind of like beat up a bit, and he kind of says, "No, don't do me. I didn't expect any of this to happen."
I'm assuming the bad mayor is the one with the dot on him.
Yes, the bad mayor is the one with the dot on him.
Okay, yeah, I'm just gonna keep my eye on this boy over here. I guess ready some reactions if need be.
Would you like to ready an action?
Let's see, what actions can I ready?
You could ready any action.
Any action.
In fact, I have all my first levels, and that means I have 4 burning hands.
Ooh.
I guess if he tries to escape, I'm going to stab him with a rapier into the ground.
Okay. And you're going to ready that action if he does that?
Yep.
Okay. So. Quest... So he has that. And is there anything else you want to do? With a bonus action or anything?
I asked the fake mayor if he wants to play a game of cards.
Sure.
Okay.
What card game?
I don't know. I got this set of cards. Let's. Do you know Magic the Gathering?
Sure. I'll try. He just looks kind of scared. He doesn't want to say no because he fears he'll get stabbed or something.
As you should.
You better be careful with that deck. That deck is my baby. I spent a while collecting this guy.
You will know pain.
I'll be careful. I guess I'm only armed with cards now.
So are you gonna play cards with the play
yeah,
cards?
I guess this is some sort of distraction. I don't fucking know.
All right, roll to see. I don't know how magic. Actually, no.
We have five people in.
Yeah, no. I backtracked immediately. I was like, nah, I'm not gonna do any good. Basically, you begin playing with him just kind of on the side as flavoring. Mm-hmm. All right, cool. And that's gonna be the end of your turn.
Damn it. Yeah.
Okay. So next is going to be this guy.
One second. My Chipotle is here.
It's fine. So what you hear is in the distance, you hear Jafar go, "We tracked you down, Zelroth. You're not going to get out of here." And Brutus just all says, "Yeah, you even got some of your cronies to impersonate us. What's up with that?" And then he says, "Listen, I don't want to hurt anyone here. I just need to get out of here."
Can Iroh hear this?
It's decently far away. Roll a perception check.
I have passive 17.
Oh, it's passive 17?
He is currently inside
the building. Oh, yeah, no. You hear this. Yeah. No, sorry.
And with the raging forest fire, probably says, like, "Bullshit, you don't."
Listen. I don't want to harm anyone here. I just want to
leave. Don't believe you. I cremated a man tonight.
Well, I'm sorry.
I'm just going to keep saying that. It's just like, you can stop this right now if you tell them all to stand down.
Will you let me leave?
Fuck no. You piece of shit.
Well, then that's your...
No pain when if you try to escape justice.
Well, it seems that I have my answer then. So, as he says that, he is going to go up to Jafar. And he's going to try to knock him out of the way.
I got food, what's up?
Nice.
Iroh's yelling at the evil man.
I see.
His name is Zelroth, by the way.
Yeah.
All right, so let's see here. Yeah, he hits with the first hit on Jafar. And he misses the second one. So that's going to be 7 pierce, or that's going to be 7 bludgeoning damage to Jafar. And with his bonus action, he's going to his eyes start to light up with a dark aura. And he says, "You will not stand in my way much longer." And that's his bonus action. And that's going to be the end of his turn. Next is Pari.
All right, so let's see, where am I? I'm going to run in. It's 5, 10, 15, 20. I'm going to tell Iroh, "I get you, you get me."
Perfect.
And as my bonus action, I am going to cast Wrathful Smite on my sword.
Okay.
And you do that. Be frightened, yeah. So my sword just glows in this like dark-looking energy, and I'm going to use my action to just like spin around and try and hit him with the Booming Blade.
Who are you trying to hit? You're trying to hit the Iroh clone?
Yeah, fake Iroh.
Fake Iroh? Okay.
And so that is?
It's a spell save of what?
Wait, I have to hit first.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
24 to hit?
Yes, that's
so gonna hit. He takes 13 slashing damage, 1d6, 2 psychic damage. And he has to make a wisdom save against spell save DC of, would it be 15 or 16 now? I think it's 16.
Because you have a magic weapon, yeah.
No. Wait, let me check.
What's your
It's 15. One? It's 15.
Okay.
It's 20.
Okay.
He fails.
He is now frightened of me.
Okay.
So yeah.
Oh, and if the Irel is a Fire Ganassi or is taking that, that doesn't matter because I have Elemental Adept.
Got it.
So the fire resistance is gone off of that if I'm using a fire spell.
Got it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so is that going to be 15 damage total?
Mm-hmm. And that's my turn.
Okay. Next, let's see. Malcolm, what is...
And now has to run away. Yeah.
Malcolm, what is your dex modifier?
My dex? It's plus 3.
Okay, roll a d20 for me.
All right.
Oh, wow. Roll again. You tied.
I swear to fucking God.
That was cocked.
18.
Yo.
Yeah. You go first.
1 second.
Jake Irel is currently scared of the smiley sword man.
Yes. Right. And he has disadvantage on all attack rolls so long as I am within his line of sight.
So that's 5.
And he cannot willingly move 20, closer to me.
20. 25, 30. And I'm going to look at the copy of myself and I'm going to say, "You will never be me." And I'm going to hit him with a inflict wounds. Actually, no. I'm going to save that.
I'm going to bonk him.
I'm going to bonk him with my scythe.
Okay.
Plus one longsword.
So who are you trying to hit right now? The fake Irel? I mean the fake Jorl?
Fake Jorl, yes.
I'm getting confused because by my own... There's a reason I put dots here. Anyways, roll the hit.
Okay. 20 plus 7. 23.
Yeah, that's going to hit.
Alright, that's going to be... 1d10...
I should also ask, is it a lethal or non-lethal?
Lethal.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Well, that's good.
It's going to be 2 on the fucking die. That's going to be 6 points of slashing damage. And 2. He has to make a wisdom saving throw.
Let's see. Sixteen.
Yeah, that passes. He doesn't shit his pants. hang on.
He's starting to look kind of worn down, though. I should mention.
Good.
How's Irel? How's fake Irel doing? He took a lot.
he still looks like pretty. He still looks decently raring to go, but you can see you've definitely had an impact on him with the hits.
And I'm going to use my bonus action to Misty Step over here.
Whoa.
Ooh. Okay. All right.
He is there.
I am there.
I got a turn yet.
I'm sorry. There's a lot of shit going on right now. I prepared this. Oh, wow. Someone subscribed. Okay. Thank you, Mason. Play the game of champion. Okay. All right. Thank you, Mason. Anyways. Let's
Dang, Mason's never subbed a meme.
Yes, I am.
Dang, Mason's never
subbed Wait, really? Before.
I'm pretty sure I am.
Yeah.
I don't think you ever have.
Well, I will.
Yeah. I'm gonna get rid of my Ludwig sub and give it to someone more who someone else. AKA just get Mason my prime probably. Alright. Next.
I pay Mason with resource money because I keep forgetting to auto renew it.
I've been paying him with money too. Anyways, where were we? Jorl just finished his turn, correct?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, there's a lot of shit to keep track of. It's a good thing I have. Okay, so. I missed. That's on me. I messed it up slightly, but it doesn't really matter. It is fake Irel's turn. Also, if someone could do me a favor and play some epic battle music, that would be much appreciated.
You got it, buddy.
Whatever you're feeling.
Castlevania. No, yes. I'm kidding.
No, I'm down for Castlevania music. No, anyways. No. Okay. So, the
for
fake Sonic Irel.
4 battle music because we're fighting ourselves.
The fake Irel who mm-hmm. is afraid. So I'm question for fear. He can still make an attack, but it's a
It is at disadvantage, and he cannot willingly move closer to me.
Okay, so he's going to try and hit the fake. Well, no, the real Iroh.
No,
it's still at disadvantage because I'm within his line of sight.
I know. Yeah, no, he's not. He's not gonna hit.
I don't think Nintendo's gonna care on this one.
Yeah, he's not gonna hit because he rolled a not great roll. So,
so what's he swinging with?
He has a. He has a short sword.
Yeah, so the way it's gonna flavor is that, like, as he's swinging down, like, I, like, insta-concentrate my body to be, like, fire where he's swinging. And then misses. Because it's cool.
And he is going to... And that's all... Actually, no, wait. Oh, yeah. He's gonna actually... Yeah, he's gonna try to hit you again.
At disadvantage.
At disadvantage, though.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he rolled a nat one, so he's going to try and hit you again, but he has no chance against you.
Okay. Does he trip and fall or something, or what's the deal?
No, we don't do crit fails here.
No, we don't. Sure. No crit fails.
Gotcha.
So he's, for flavor's sake, he stumbles when he tries to. It's not enough to be knocked prone or anything. He stumbles when he tries to hit you, but he misses.
I'm going to look at him, and I'm just going to say, scared of the real deal, huh? And he has to make a wisdom save. He has to make a wisdom save again for the fear effect.
He rolls a natural 19.
Yeah, passes.
Okay.
That's fine.
So, I'm assuming he's no longer afraid?
Nope.
Okay.
No, that was short-lived.
Noted. Okay, that's going to be the end of his turn. Next is going to be... Yeah, Malcolm already went. So it's going to be... Fake Lockhart. Fake Lockhart is going to say... I am a human. And then he's going to walk up to... He's going to go up to Iroh. Mm-hmm. And
is he gonna swing?
Yeah, they don't actually have our abilities, they're just fake mm-hmm. us.
Yeah.
You're not me.
You're not me.
Why is there realistic indoor plumbing over here?
That's a good question.
Yeah, why is there actually a vest?
Yeah, there's indoor plumbing over here. My immersion is broken.
Please ignore that. That's not a real toilet.
No, it's too late, my immersion.
What? No. No.
No. Dude. Okay, no, that's it. Jarrell's taking another turn. He's going. No, I'm kidding.
No. Okay. Also, yeah, it's Lockhart's turn. He is going to try to hit Iroh. he rolled. Wow. He rolled a nat one. So he.
Yeah, that's beautiful. About right.
He tries to hit you with his short sword.
Mm-hmm.
And he just sucks. He just fails.
Wow, you must be method.
Yeah,
you're so not you're not a human. I'm a human.
I'm just like, who are you talking to right now?
I'm gonna look at the fake Lockhart and say you're a farce is what you are.
Oof, got him. Dab on him.
I don't know about that. You look like the real fake to me.
Iroh.
You're
that fake Lockhart around here.
Well, no, so I see that because he swung at me. I'm just going to say, you know metal melts, right?
Are you going to heat that shit?
I don't think if he's a chainsaw.
No, so that's the point. That's the point.
He looks kind
of... I always want to find out.
He looks kind of half scared.
Well, don't worry. I'll kill myself.
Nice. So, Lockhart, or fake Lockhart.
Sorry, I accidentally rolled.
That's going to be the end of his turn.
Okay. Wait, no, it didn't go through. Okay.
Yeah. That's going
to go yet? I literally have just been sitting here.
I'm sorry, this is going to take a while. So, that's the end of Lockhart's, Big Lockhart's turn. Next
just,
is
just
going
rush through the NPC turns.
Yeah, sorry.
Like, just do it. Just know what they're gonna do and just.
Yeah, I already know what they're gonna do. So this Brutus right here, he's gonna come over and he's actually going to attack you.
Oh, you can certainly try.
So he's going to roll to hit. He rolls a 19.
Cool.
So that's going to be... Let's see what this is. Wow, that's going... that's going to be 9 slashing damage.
So 2 because of my temp HP. Gotcha.
Yes. So he's going to hit you. It's going to say... You fake...
I'm going to take the hit, and then I'm just going to slowly turn around towards him, because I'm still in my form of dread. And
form
I,
of
and then
dread.
I say,
the sheer audacity.
Okay, so that's going to be the end of this guy's turn. Next, it's going to be Fake Pari, and he is going to try to also... Well, he's going to also try to hit Hyrule. He rolls a, wow, he rolls a nat 20 on his first hit. So that's going to be...
Oh, first hit.
Wow. That's going to be 12 slashing damage on the first hit.
You're fine with it.
First hit.
And, right. Yeah, second hit.
Oh, Tommy, no.
That's going to be a 21.
Yeah.
21?
21.
Yeah.
Oh, that's fine. You got two of you are about to get big.
That's going to be another 8 damage.
Jeez, is this guy packing a greatsword?
He is multi-attack.
No, but like, what is he wielding?
Yeah.
He's wielding a short sword. I just rolled well. Yeah.
Short sword's a d6.
Yeah, yeah. I was rolling
you
didn't a d6.
Roll 8.
No, I rolled a d6. No, because 5 plus. I rolled a nat 20, so 5 plus 3.
No. The second one was. He attacked
it,
again, yeah?
It was, yeah, because he has plus 3. 5 plus 3.
Okay.
No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry if that wasn't clear. He is a short sword, so I've been rolling d6s. I'm not bamboozling him. Don't worry. But that's.
Suddenly I'm rolling 2d8s.
At the end of his turn, his sword is glowing blue. And that's going to be the end of his turn. So next is going to be the Mayor Changeling. He's gonna make a run for it.
Oh boy, well, guess what that's
gonna But he's
be.
Going, but before that, he's going to try to distract Teeny.
Yeah?
So,
he's about to get stabbed.
He's going to go, hey, look over there, your card flew away. Roll an.
It was in the graveyard anyway.
Roll an insight check with advantage.
Let's see. Insight with advantage.
If your character wouldn't fall for this, then they're not gonna fall for it.
Yeah.
Yeah, you see through his ruse. You just immediately can do whatever you want to him because he's trying to run away from you.
Stab.
Cool.
So you have an opportunity attack on him.
Sweet. Stabby stab.
Yes.
Stabby stab.
Stabby stab.
Stabby stabby.
Yeah.
Right between the throat and the jaw.
Roll to hit.
No sneak attack, though?
That's going to be 22.
Well,
AKA,
oh, right.
That's gonna,
I have
yeah,
to
that's,
have declare sneak attack beforehand, don't I?
No.
You don't have a trigger for
oh,
sneak
yeah, I don't have,
yeah.
I don't have, yeah, no.
You don't
no,
have
don't
a trigger, have but you get it. You hit him.
Oh. Yeah.
So it's just
the
Yeah. Please roll for damage, if you don't mind.
Nope, that's roll to hit.
You can click the rapier.
Yeah, click the rapier.
Yeah.
Okay,
That's going to be.
Oh wait, I took I shit. I took the piercing the piercer. Feat. Gotta remember that.
Is that relevant this turn?
Mm-hmm.
I thought it's only if it's a nat.
Oh, 20. If only if I score a crit. Okay. Never mind. Yeah.
So that's going to be 9 damage to him. And he's kind of battered up. He goes like, I don't want to play your card game.
You're going to watch me storm off and you're going to like it.
So he's going to, he's kind of injured. He's going to move over here after getting stabbed. And he's trying to make a run for it. He didn't quite get the opportunity to just like run away because he got Yenictum.
I see.
And that's going to be the end of his turn. Though he's a bit bloodied, he looks like he's going to not be in a good spot. Next, we have... 15. Okay. Next, we are going to have... Fake Jor-El. I'm sorry, there's a lot of NPCs. So Fake Jor-El is going to run up to Pari, and he's going to try and hit you with his short sword.
I'm just going to look at him.
Can't be any sharper than my edge.
Yeah, just, you have no flair.
Are you sure about that? He rolls it. He rolls a 24 to hit you.
Hits.
All right.
Nami, by the way, you say if people have advantage or disadvantage because I have an ability to cancel it.
Gotcha. I did say that no one has had advantage or disadvantage yet.
I was being attacked with advantage or disadvantage. Yeah.
No, yeah, he was with it was with disadvantage, so I assume he wouldn't want to cancel that out.
No,
but
I wouldn't.
Anyways,
cancel.
That's
I just want to.
No, I understand.
No, thanks wait, can you cancel an enemy rolling with advantage?
Yeah.
Yeah. No. You can. Enemy hasn't rolled with advantage.
That's what I was saying. I wanted Tommy to say if he was rolling with advantage or not.
I wasn't. He wasn't.
In general.
No, that's fine. But if I don't say I'm rolling with advantage, just assume that I'm not rolling with advantage.
Okay.
Also, Vinay, you take 6 slashing damage.
That's fine.
And he's just going to say, listen. He just kind of looks away. We're you?
No, you're not.
He looks confused.
All you are is a farce. Just give it up already.
I don't know about that one.
If he was really me, then he would have gone ghost.
Yeah, he's just like...
Or cast
be edgy.
Alright, that's going to be end of Fake Drell's turn. Now it is...
You didn't cast Eldritch Blast, it's just not me.
Now it's going to be Jafar's turn. Or this Jafar's turn.
Yeah, we know
it's
Jafar.
Yeah, I think it's pretty obvious who the real ones are. Or, no, that's wrong. Let me just mark this since it's pretty obvious based on the positioning. So, the real Jafar is going to say, no! We've tracked you down. We're not letting you slip out. And he's going to try to hit. At focus section. He is going to try to hit Zelroth. And with Brutus right next to him, with that proc sneak attack.
They're attacking this guy?
Yeah, this guy.
It's anyone within 5 feet.
Okay.
And he's diagonally 5 feet.
Okay, yep. So he's going to also, he's going to roll a hit, and he also gets sneak attack defense. He rolls a, let's see.
Tommy, if this is between two, like, NPCs, then we don't need
to hear it. You don't need to hear it. He misses. Next is going to be, sorry, I'm managing a lot of things at once. Next, Brutus. Brutus is going to try to hit him. Or, well, with his bonus action, he's going to turn into a werewolf. So, just mark him as werewolf. And he is going to hit. I should keep track of. bad feeling so far. That is going to... yeah, that's going to hit him. So that's going to be... Okay, he's going to take 8 damage. And that's going to be the end of Brutus's turn. And now it's going to be fake Jafar's turn. He is going to also try to hit Jarell with his short sword.
All right, buddy.
He misses. And he goes, I don't care how scary you are, you're the fake.
I do the slow turn again. and then I say,
what a fake, do this. And I'm gonna wait until my turn to do that.
Okay. That's the end of Fake Jafar's turn. Now it's Brutus, and then it's finally time for Park. Or no, wait, no. Now it's actually Park's turn.
Lock Hart.
I waited that long and I'm not even gonna attack. So I'm gonna
sorry.
Run up. And I'm gonna I'm gonna run up. Okay, let's see.
Just speed up the NPC turns.
I'm going to. Sorry.
5, 10. I'll stand in the doorway. So I'm gonna look at Teeny while I run by and I go, get the guy. And then I'm gonna twin spell enlarge reduce on Pari and Jarell.
Woo!
Where's Jarell?
Jarell's up here.
I am over here.
Oh, I can't reach Jarell.
Sorry.
Big Irel.
I'm gonna shrink,
what?
Fake Pari.
Oh. Ooh.
Okay. Fake Pari.
Big Pari, little Pari.
So, yeah, big Pari, little Pari.
Let's go.
Con 16.
I'm just going to, mark you so that I know you're,
Big Pari,
so
little
big
Pari.
Big Pari is big, little Pari, or big Pari is
you
little...
have to roll for a little Pari.
Yeah.
Did he... also Pari like changes size category, so he has...
he rolled what was the save?
16.
He failed.
Yo, okay. So he drops a d4 on his attacks, and he has disadvantage on strength checks, and Pari gets a d4 to his attacks.
Okay.
And has advantage on strength checks. Let me see if there's anything else. I think that's basically it. Enlarge. Strength checks, strength saving throws, yeah. So 1d4 to your attacks, and you have advantage on strength saves and skill checks.
Nice.
And then he has the opposite. And then I'm gonna drop another point to quicken. Wait, hold on. Where's quicken?
Oh yeah, Malcolm. I forgot to mention this earlier. You because you're nearby.
Oh boy.
You do see who you assume, based on resemblance, to be the...
just 4 points at once.
Is there anything else you're doing with
Yeah,
your action?
I'm quickening, Firebolt at, let's see, I'm gonna do it at fake, Jafar.
Okay, roll the hit.
That'd actually be very helpful, thank you.
Firebolt.
Yeah, that's gonna hit. I roll for damage.
6.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna back up so I don't get hit and lose my concentration.
Okay. So you hit fake Jafar and he goes like, oh, it burns! And then, you go away. And you get back.
Jafar unto me.
Yes, that is the end of my turn.
Okay. So, start of the order.
Pari, you better make that. Pari, you better make that worth.
Teeny.
Tyler, it's your turn. But before that, Jarell.
Tommy, you have to make You have to make Pari big.
Yeah.
No,
Pari
no.
Pari is 4x4 now, or 2x2.
He's 2x2 right now.
Or like he's 2x. I'm trying to
he's
make.
Just, sure. He's knocked. The flavor is he's knocked this Jarell away.
Yeah, I'm just gonna make this. Yeah, so that works. I'm sorry. So Pari is big now. You go big, Jarell just steps back, the fake Jarell goes like, ah! You're big now.
And
so,
then little Pari.
And then Pari shrinks.
Like a little piss baby.
And he's really small. I can't make him go any smaller, though. But he's small. And that's the end of your turn.
Get him, Pari.
Yes. And top of the order, Jarell, you hear this because you're in the general area.
Oh, wait. Oh, sorry.
Oh, it's Teeny. I know it's Teeny. I'm saying prepare your action, but something.
Oh, happened. I forgot to flavor my spell. So
it's fine.
When I cast it on Pari, he hears like tick, 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 like a clock. Mm-hmm. And it's like time is accelerating and he grows years had passed.
Interesting.
All right. So he grows?
Yeah.
And that happens.
Yes.
Yeah, that's true. Okay, so at the top of the order, Tyler, prepare your action, but before that, Jarell, you see a man who looks eerily similar to the senator, who you can assume to be his son, and he says, "Listen, I don't have my weapon right now, but you have to stop that man. He stole our heirloom, which is more valuable than you could imagine. Trust me."
What was the last thing he said?
He said, basically, he said, he doesn't have a weapon right now, he can't fight, but this guy is carrying something extremely an orb, he said, an extremely valuable orb.
He signed his death warrant before I even came here.
And, now it's Dean's turn.
Okay. I really should have tied this guy up.
Rogues can schmoove.
Yeah.
I feel like that'd be an
Rogues can schmoove.
I know.
Yeah.
If you want, you can go up to him and try to tie him up.
Yeah, I think that's probably the smart move.
Alright. So you're gonna move up to him and try to grapple him and tie him up?
Yep. It's time to go to sideboarding.
All right. I'm going to say roll with either athletics or acrobatics, whichever you choose.
100% acrobatics.
Yep.
That's a 19.
You rolled higher than him. So you see the fake mayor run away, and just as about he's ready to give you the slip, you run up, you tackle him, and you tie him up. So, you do that to him, and he goes, "Ah, damn it!" And he is, you've restrained him, so he can't really move at this point.
Can I slice his Achilles just in case?
Is that
a thing I can do?
I'm gonna say you did, use your action to, grapple him and tackle him, but if you want to do that on your next action, you can hit him.
Okay.
But, yeah. Is that going to be the end of your turn?
Let's see. Where was I? I can't start, like, dragging him back until...
Next turn.
Next turn, yeah.
Okay. I would say, yeah, you can until next turn.
Okay. Well, I guess I'm just going to keep my eye on him again.
Okay.
Make sure no funny business is occurring.
All right. All right, that's the end of your turn. That's going to be Iryl.
Yep.
Iryl's next.
So Iryl, after taking that hit, as he's taking the hit, he's sort of like gritting his teeth, and then he draws with his hands like the symbol for fire from his home, which I haven't decided yet. And when he finishes, he has like finger guns because he's cast Scorching Ray.
Okay.
And he's going to...
Who's he trying to hit?
Well, he's going to hit the three in front of him.
You'll kill Tiny Pari.
So, fake Lockhart, fake Pari, and fake Iryl?
Fake Iryl, yeah.
Alright.
Oh, nat 20 on the first one. Which is... who's looking the worst?
Oh, do it on who's looking the best.
Yeah, and that's what I mean. Who's looking the best? Fake Pari did a number on him.
Fake Pari has not been hit yet.
Oh, yeah.
Fake Pari did a number on him.
Oh, sweet. I made the one who hadn't been hit yet small. I was not paying attention enough to know that.
But he rolled net 20 on it, so he's fine.
Yeah.
So 4d6. I'll just roll that twice, actually.
Yeah.
So that is
17 on him.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, it counted with an advantage. Oh, that's sick. And so I'm going to roll the next one. 17 on fake IRL.
Okay. 17 barely hits. Yes.
I wonder why. So that's 7 fire damage.
He is looking a bit shaken up at this point.
And I say, he's just like, and I say as it hits him, I'm just like, real me would have absorbed that.
He's like, he's just silent. He's stunned. Not literally stunned, but he's taken aback.
And then 17 for Lockhart.
Yeah, that also hits.
Fake Lockhart.
Yeah, that hits fake Lockhart. You hit fake Lockhart. He unsurprisingly does not melt at all, and he's like, ah!
And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to have my spirit hover down and fiery teleport me here. I can do 20 feet. So that's one. I have to roll that, so it is 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 20 feet. And grab me. And then... Ah, oh, shit. That hit Pari.
It's fine.
Is it fine?
It's fine, it's fine.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, is true. It all creatures or all hostile creatures?
It's all creatures.
It's all creatures.
Okay. That's fine.
So I have to pull up... I'm sorry, I have to pull up the... that block. I didn't have that up. Yeah.
Please do that.
Yeah. I'm doing that real quick.
Let me see who's next.
Yeah, okay. So, a d6 plus proficiency bonus with my... So it's a DC with my... everyone has to make a DC 16. This whole group, besides the fake Jarell, has to make a DC 16. Okay. Dex save.
Dex save? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so first is fake Lockhart. Fails. Next is fake Pari.
Mm-hmm.
He's
real party also failed.
wow. So fake Pari succeeds, real Pari fails, and fake Hyrule also fails. So 2 fails, 1 success.
So everyone's taken people who failed take 4 fire damage, people succeed take 2 fire damage.
Okay.
Smack. Easy.
Alright. Yeah. I should mention that fake Lockhart is looking pretty bad at this point. So, you come in, fire ablazing, you do a number on him.
Mm-hmm. Is the fake IRL still up?
Yes.
Okay.
Is that all you're gonna... Is that your turn?
That is my turn, yeah.
Alright, so... It is Zelroth's turn. He's gonna say to Defar, "Move out the way. Listen, even if I knock you out, I'm not going to kill you. Just move." And he's just... Jafar is standing there. He's just like, "No, I'm not moving."
So weak as to not move him yourself.
And he is going to try and hit him. He is going to
speed
hit. Yeah, he's going to hit with the first one. So that's going to be first one. In addition, he's going to get the 2d6 from his flavored Thunder Smite. So that's going to be 9 plus. That's going to be 16 damage to Jafar. He is not looking very good. So, yeah, he gets hit. And not looking good at all. Okay. Next is going to be... I miscalculated his HP. Sorry. But yeah, that's the... Oh, wait, no, he's still a Ace Roller.
Just
Yeah, rolls nat one, skip. Next turn. Yeah, he's looking pretty bad.
But anyways, after him, now it's gonna be Perry's turn.
So...
Ari... Better pop off with that spell, because I waited like 40 minutes. One spell.
Wait, can you do Thunder Wave?
Not Thunder Wave, actually. So I'm gonna see everyone around me, and I'm just gonna sigh, and stick my sword into the ground, and I am casting Arms of Hadar.
Ooh. Okay.
So, everyone has to make a strength save.
Wait, how did you get that?
Magic initiative.
Oh.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, okay. Ignore the 26. They have to make a DC 15 dex save. Okay. Or strength save.
Okay, so, fake Ari has disadvantage, correct?
Yeah. Yes, it was useful.
Yes, he does.
It was useful. Yes, I did something.
Okay, wow. Holy shit, he rolled a natural 17 with this.
I waited like 15 minutes. I waited like 30 minutes.
Alright, so, fake Perry rolled a 17.
With disadvantage?
That's yes, crazy. Somehow. Fake Iroll fails. What did you say the DC was?
What? 15.
Fake Lockhart also fails.
And fake Jarl, he's also in range.
Yes. He was a 15 or 16?
15.
He succeeds. So two failures,
that's fine.
Two successes.
Cast at first level. Oh, come on. Really? Whatever. They all take 3 necrotic and halved to 1. That's fine.
So that's going to be 3 on fake Lockhart.
Dang, that was a bummer.
Happens.
It's going to be 9 on turn. Okay. 23. Okay.
Question to DM. Is it all druids or just land druids that get their spells back on a short?
Land.
Just land, okay.
Yeah,
I was
land.
Just making sure.
Okay. Hmm. And someone please loot the music again.
No, I'm going to play a song.
Please play a song. All right.
I wonder what it's going
to
be.
Okay, so that's going to be the... do you have anything else you want to do with your turn, Vinay?
Let's see. Pari has disadvantage on strength, right?
Or no. Yeah. Fake Pari has disadvantage on strength.
All right, let's channel divinity him.
Ooh.
Wait, let me just check real quick.
Actually, wait. What's the range on that channel divinity?
30 feet.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wait.
Yes.
10 feet. 10 feet. Channel divinity is 10 feet.
It still
hits all of them.
Yeah, it still hits them.
It still hits them.
So I'm going to channel divinity nature's wrath, unless they are not. They're humanoids. Never mind.
They are humanoids. Yes.
Yeah.
Nature's wrath.
Oops,
so that is a
name on accident.
That is a strength or dex save. And it is restrained for 1 minute if it fails.
All right, so you said strength or dex?
Until it takes 10. Strength or dex.
All right,
it's choice.
He's going to be using dex.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so let's see what happens. 11, so that's going to be a failure.
Failed. That is a fail. He is restrained.
Yeah, so he is restrained for the next minute. So I believe he can't move, right? Or do anything?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yes, he is restrained.
Alright.
So he can't move, he can't take actions, I don't think.
Alright, so you do that, and he drops his sword to the ground, and he's like, ah!
Try this on, like, idiot. I'm bad at shit talking.
It's fine. So is that going to be your turn?
Yeah, that's all my turn is.
Okay. Next is going to be fake Iroll. Fake Iroll is going to. Oh wait, where's real Iroll? Oh yeah, real Iroll is here. Yes.
Yeah. Poofed away.
Makes sense. Fake Iroll is going to try to hit Perry.
Mm-hmm.
With first attack. That's going to miss. Or actually, mm-hmm. That's going to miss.
19 is my AC.
Yeah. Miss both. Fake Iroll is going to try to hit you. Misses both times.
I'm just going to look at look at him and just disappointment.
he's like taken aback at your look of disappointment.
Real Iron wouldn't have missed.
He grimaces.
Fuck yeah, I wouldn't have. Fuck yeah, I wouldn't have.
With the weapon. He grimaces at you. Next is going to be luck. Well, no, Malcolm.
Fake heart.
Malcolm is next.
Fake heart.
All right, roll those opportunity attacks. I'm hitting this guy with fucking inflict wounds.
This guy?
Yeah. All right. Yeah, the main villain, the brick wall.
All right. So, you're gonna try and inflict wounds him?
Yeah.
Okay.
The fake boys there also get opportunity attacks on me, but I do not care. I am fucking this guy up. 13. Fuck.
That's going to miss. And they're both going to take an opportunity attack on you.
Glad. Great. Love that turn.
So, first.
Yeah. See you guys in 45 minutes.
First is fake Jafar.
I know how I feel.
He misses.
Okay.
Fake Brutus rolls a dirty 20.
All right.
Wait, can he even reach from that range?
I moved out of his range.
Wait, Tommy, Tyler pointed out something important. Yes. Would I be able to see up here? Or is that just the way the house looks?
You would be able to see that area. But there's nothing notable in that area, really. Okay. But you would be able to see it. I guess at this point I can
that was my last spell plot too. God fucking damn it.
Yeah, you can see over here, but there's nothing immediately in the area. That's going to be 9 slashing damage to Jarrell.
Alright.
From Brutus. Is that going to be your turn?
Can't do fucking anything else. What else do I have? Double checking my bullshit. Can't do anything.
Okay. That's going to be the end of your turn, then.
I'm gonna make him piss his pants, though.
Oh. Are you gonna... So, wisdom saving throw?
Wisdom save.
Alright.
I believe him.
Oh, shit. He rolls a natural 17.
My ass. Alright.
So, he does not piss his pants, and that's the end of your turn?
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Okay. So, next... It's going to be fake Lockhart. Mm. So, fake Lockhart.
Gonna miss again.
Yeah. fake Lockhart.
Because that's
me. fake Lockhart is kind of just like, I'm the true human. And he's going to.
None of them are even human. Who is he talking to?
Good question. Ooh. Good question. He's going to run up to Iroll, and he's gonna say,
uh-oh,
that's enough of you, and he's going to try to hit you. He misses.
Yeah, crazy.
And he's just kind of gonna look at you, and he's gonna say,
my eyes are still like flaming wildly, and whenever I speak it's like the roaring forest fire.
He looks scared of you.
So yeah.
Okay, so next is going to be fake Brutus. Fake Brutus is going to go up to Jarrell, and he's going to say, you're not getting away that easily. And he's going to try to hit you. That's going to be a 25. Wow. Alright, so that's going to be 8 slashing damage. Malcolm?
What?
Malcolm?
Oh.
I was taking a nap.
Oh. You okay?
What do you think? Alright.
Did you hear what I said? Or no?
What did you... He came up to attack me again? Cool.
Yeah,
how much?
8. He hit you, and rolled, he got 8 damage. With the short sword.
Alright. I'm going back to sleep.
No. Oh. Well. Okay. So that's gonna be the end of his turn. Next is fake Pari. He can't do anything. So.
He can make the save again.
Or he's gonna try to make the save.
Wait, what did you do to him?
I restrained him.
And no. What did you say the DC was?
15.
15 what?
And it's strength, I think, to break out. I'm not sure.
Used it, right?
Is it strength
nature's or wrath? It's strength or dexterity. The creature was strength or dex.
Oh.
It's choice, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm. Oh wow. He barely succeeds to escape using dex. Whatever.
Dang.
So he uses his action to get out, so he's not going to be able to do anything else.
Yeah.
Next, after a fake party, it's going to be the mayor changeling.
Oh.
He can't really do anything.
Thought he was here. Oh.
Is he tied up?
Yeah, he's tied up. He's just tied up there. He can't do anything.
Okay.
Now we gotta get Teeny into the fight.
Dash.
Yeah. Get moving. I should mention that he can't. He's hogtied. He can't really move. So.
Perfect.
All right.
So next, after the mayor changeling, it is going to be fake Jor-El.
So fake Jor-El is going to try to hit parry. A 18 barely misses, so he's not going to hit you. And yeah, he looks like he's getting progressively more scared.
I'm
rich blast, buddy.
I am also disappointed in him.
All right. So that's going to be the end of his turn. Next is going to be Jafar. He's going to be saying, "No, you're not getting past me." And he's going to try to hit him. He rolls a natural 20.
On who?
Jafar rolls a natural 20 on this guy.
On the wall.
Yeah, on that guy.
On the brick wall.
Yeah, on the brick wall. So Jafar rolls a nat 20 on the brick wall. And he also gets a sneak attack bonus.
Yeah, that gets double too.
So it's... So, first, I roll the 2d8. That's going to be 11 plus... I'm just trying to make sure. At level 4, how many dice do you get for sneak attack? Is it 3? I believe it's 3. It is? Yeah, okay, just make sure. So, wow, that's going to be 66.
Wait, no, I lied. It's 2d6.
Campus Wi-Fi died.
Okay.
That sucks.
Okay. So that's going to be...
Oh, no. Teeny.
Hey, he's still in the game.
Well, he said it in chat.
That's going to... Wow, so Jafar is going to do 23 damage.
So who?
Zelroth.
Wow.
So he is not looking too great, and he says, "Damn it, what do you have in you?" And that's going to be the end of Jafar's turn. So after Jafar is going to be Brutus, who is also going to try to hit the brick wall. He's going to miss. And that's going to be the end of his turn. Next is going to be Fake Jafar, who is going to try to hit Jor-El. He's going to stay where he is. And he's going to try to hit Jor-El.
Go ahead.
Wow. Oh my fucking god, are you serious? He rolled he rolled a nat 20.
Alright, cool.
Okay. That's going to be 10 slashing damage.
Alright.
And that's the end of his turn.
That's it?
Yeah, he does 10 slashing damage to you.
Okay, someone else can put a battle song on. Didn't he get sneak attack? This one has looked like 5 times.
No, he doesn't have sneak attack.
Why? He's got an ally next to him.
Hey, he's not a rogue.
No, he's not a rogue.
Oh, I'm an idiot? Alright.
Okay, someone else can put a battle song on. That one looked like 5 times.
No, he doesn't get sneak attack.
Alright.
Anyways, Whoops, I accidentally left.
Oh no! Oh no!
Nice.
I'm sorry. I'm coming back in. Please. Sorry. Holy shit. Okay. Right. So next, after a fake Jafar, Park, prepare your turn while I am getting back in.
Oh, okay, it's my turn.
Yes.
Park.
So park. I'm gonna run it. I'm gonna see these three guys. I'm going to use my bonus action. Ooh, wait. I'm going to cast quickened. Yeah, so I'm going to quicken Scorching Ray. One. So I'm splitting the rolls between these three guys.
Okay.
Please
roll to hit.
Okay, I am now out of sorcery points.
Cantrip, man.
Yeah.
Also, Tyler, please prepare your turn.
So yeah, Scorching Ray three times. 1, 2, 3.
Okay, and who are you hitting respectively?
If you don't mind me telling me. 1, 2, 3. These guys.
By no, party. I know. Are you hitting?
Yeah, they're going 1, 2, 3. Jarell, Irel, and Pari.
Okay. Thank you for the clarification.
Help me out a little here, buddy.
We're going. Irel's making his way.
Oh, wow, you are really deep in.
Yeah.
I can't even.
I thought that things would cooperate.
Things have not been going well over there.
I'll run through once these guys are dead. Yeah, but I can't. I only have 13 AC, so I can't get up there without taking a bunch of attack.
I would like to continue. So
yeah.
Yes.
18, 14, 21.
18 hits Terrell, hits fake Terrell, misses fake Irel, hits fake Perry. So that's two hits and a miss.
Really?
Man. Okay, so fake Irel still standing, barely holding on. Fake Terrell looks like he's about to collapse. Holy shit.
Jor-El?
No, I...
Ari, okay.
Ari, I misspoke.
And then I'm going to Mind Sliver.
You're going to try to Mind Sliver who?
Ari. Wait,
that's a bonus action?
Is that I quickened.
Oh, you quickened that. Yeah, that's right. I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah, you did.
So, int 16.
16. Saving throw of what?
Instant.
Int.
Intelligence.
Oh, he succeeds.
Okay, it does no damage.
F.
Back out here.
Okay. Also, feel free to put in more battle music at your leisure. Anyways, is that the end of your turn?
Yeah, I can think of a good one. Someone else can do it.
Okay. Next, Tyler, go.
Okay. How much does this fake man's weigh?
If he's hogtied, he's not going.
You hogtied him with your action.
Well, I'm trying to drag him back.
Oh, I would say if you're trying to drag him back. I would say,
just need him in the fight, man. We need the rogue in the fight.
I'm going to say make a strength check to see if you can move the normal amount.
My normal occurring in my sheet is 330.
Yeah, you have full movement.
Awesome. Okay, I'm gonna, drag him to this spot that I'm in right now.
And then drop him off.
And then drop him off, and then tell the real mayor to sit on him.
Okay. the mayor proceeds. The mayor, who is not involved in this at all, just walks over, and he just sits on him. Because he's scared and he doesn't know what else to do with himself. Is that the end of your turn?
That's my movement, yeah.
Okay. Next
can
is
I
going...
See, can I see any enemies? I got a short bow.
You're right in front of the entrance. So you can see him. You can see two people, but Pari is in the way of fake Irel and fake Jarell. I mean fake Jarell and fake Irel. The only one you got a clear shot in is fake Perry. If you want to go for that.
What is the skull over there?
It means he's small. Tiny. It means he's small.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I shrunk him.
Yeah, that's just for my reference.
Cool.
So if you want to hit him with your short bow, roll the hit.
Okay, I'm just saying, do I have any sneaky things I can do? Does he, like, he know I'm there?
I would say you don't. He doesn't notice you until you are shooting at him, because you have not been anywhere near the action. So yeah, I'm gonna say you would have sneak attack bonus.
Okay.
If you hit.
So let's please pull up the hitties over here.
Also, I am trying to make this go faster. That is going to.
Damn, that's unlucky.
I'm gonna say you have advantage, actually. On this one, because he does not see you.
Or.
Okay.
So roll one more time. Yeah. That's going.
A little bit more.
Yep. That's going to hit him.
Awesome.
So okay. He doesn't notice you. Oh. And you go up to the doorway and you shoot at a fake Pari. Roll for damage.
Oh, it was the bot.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So.
Come on, please kill fake Pari. He's so low.
Please. Please.
Let's see. That's an extra
2d6.
Extra 2d6.
Okay.
So please roll.
So there's short bow.
Okay, that's 6. Oh, oof.
Roll 2d6. And I, for piercer, I can reroll any one damage die. Yeah, reroll that.
Yeah, you can re-roll the one.
Yeah, I'm re-rolling that one. Slash roll.
Nice.
So.
Okay.
10, what, 17.
It's going to be 17. He is about to collapse. He looks like.
Do they have our house?
he looks like a breeze will blow him over.
Tommy did look at our sheet before the game.
Yeah. I think they have our health. Alright. Okay. So that's Teeny's turn?
That's Teeny. Now it's Iril's turn. I should mention that Pari Doppelganger. Pari Doppelganger, Jorel Doppelganger, and Lockhart Doppelganger.
Doppelganger,
Changeling, whatever the fuck.
Doppelganger.
Doppelgamer, yes. whatever they are, those three all look terrible. So all
right.
Do what you will.
Okay, so first course of action, my Wildfire Spirit is just gonna fly right above Jarrell, with the 30 feet, and he's gonna hold his hand down and just say, "Yo," like to pull him out of there.
Okay.
Jarrell gonna take the hand.
God, I really want to fuck this guy up.
Are you gonna take it?
Hey man, everything's taking a D5. Everything's taking a dex save.
I'm looking around, and I'm like,
Oh wait,
it's not worth it because I'm at 7 hit points. I'm taking the hand.
All right. Yeah, and so you're gonna poof.
So
right here.
Who is that going to hit? By the way.
5. Like the square around him is within 5 feet.
And please move him to where you want to move him if you don't mind.
Yeah, so I can go 20 feet. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. And you're going on top of the bar.
Okie dokie.
And my eye rolls is just going to be floating above you, the spirit.
Okay.
And so while he does that, I'm going to boom. Pull out my quarterstaff and boom on it, and it got a little fire on it, and I cast Shillelagh on it. I'm about to bonk Fae Cart.
Roll to hit, please, if you don't mind.
Yep, I'm gonna bonk Fae Cart real quick.
Lethal or non-lethal, by the way?
Of course, I'll die first.
I'm just hitting him across the head, like I'm not with like no intent to kill, with intent to hurt. If that makes sense.
So you're just gonna knock him out, okay?
Yeah.
All right. Please roll to hit.
13.
You don't even need to roll for damage. He's just knocked out. And
okay.
He just goes, ah! And he's down.
All right.
Is that going to be your turn?
Yeah, and oh, Jarell, you're over here now.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
And he does not get opportunity attack, if I remember.
Yep, correctly. And then these guys all have to make a DC 16 dex save.
Okay.
The badman.
All right. So Firth is going to be Zelroth. Zelroth,
which is
sucks.
This guy, right?
Yes.
Yeah, the evil man.
Zelroth. Let's see. He succeeds.
That's fine.
Next is going to be Fake Brutus. Wow, he also succeeds.
That's fine.
Fake Jafar fails.
Okay. All right, so 6 for Fake Jafar, and then 3 for the rest of them.
Okay, so that's 3 to Zelroth. Also, someone more music. That's going to be... Yep, 18, Fake Brutus is going to be... Wow, okay, that's going to be... All right, is that going to be your turn? Or is there anything else you can do?
I'm going to run over by Jarell and make a choke, and then I'm going to have my hand on him. And the first thing I'm doing is prepping cure wounds. The second, my next turn and goes off.
All right, and that's gonna be your turn for now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Next is going to be Zelroth, and he's going to say, you've got more in you than I expected, but this is the last that you can do for now. And he's going to bring up his sword, and he is going to do the same thing he did before, where dark lightning comes out of his sword. And he is going to hit the first one. And that's going to be... Yeah, Jafar goes unconscious. Jafar goes unconscious.
Our Jafar or the other Jafar?
Our Jafar.
Our Jafar.
Our no.
Goodman Jafar.
Our Jafar goes unconscious. And he is going to... take a swing at Brutus now. Where is my d20? Shit, there it is. And he is going to miss Brutus, but Jafar is unconscious. He is going to try to move over Jafar, but that's going to be difficult terrain. So. Let me just get the reveal area. Sorry. He's going to get about here. And he also procs a opportunity attack from Brutus. Who misses him. And he's going to say, it's about time that I leave.
No.
As promised... I will not kill the boy, but I am gone as soon as possible. So, yeah, he does. He stays true to his word. He does not attack Jafar after knocking him out, and that's going to be the end of his turn.
Is he? Oh, he's out there. All right.
Yeah.
We can't let him leave. Oh, he already went over him. Okay.
Yeah, he already went over Jafar's unconscious body. Next, it's going to be Pari. Yes. Big Pari.
All right.
Big Pari, go. Get him.
There's still 3 people over here. Ah, oh, shit.
I know, right?
I can't even reach him if I wanted to.
I also should mention, this is what he looks like.
Okay.
But, yeah.
An evil man, for sure.
So,
you can tell that he's wearing red and black.
I'm going to see Fake Jarell over here.
Volunteers on the weekends.
I'm just gonna smack him upside the head with my longsword.
Roll the hit.
Nat 1.
Woo! So,
You miss. Yeah. You stumble a bit, but that's flavoring.
Don't you get plus four?
Huh?
No, that's damage.
Oh, okay, no.
You don't lose your sword or anything, like nothing like that. But for flavoring, you stumble and fake Drell then says back to you.
Can I just hit my head on the ceiling as I'm trying to swing?
Yes, you can just you hit your head on the ceiling and then Drell goes like.
I'm just gonna be like, ah, shit, not used to this.
You good there? He just
looks. Drell or
fake Drell just kind of looks like he's about to like piss his pants.
Good. And that is all I can do on my turn.
I'm not gonna.
Okay, so, next.
Thank you, Marshall character.
Okay, so next is gonna be a fake Iroll, who is going to try to hit you again.
Mm-hmm.
13 is going to miss with his first attack. Second attack, that is cocked. Second attack is a 19.
That hits.
So he's going to hit you for 7 slashing damage.
7 slashing, alright. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, oh, okay.
And that's going to be the end of his turn. Next, it is going to be after the fake Iroll, it will be Lockhart, or fake Lockhart is unconscious.
Fake Heart's out of here.
Yeah, fake Heart is out of here. So now, or no, yeah, it's Jarrell.
Hmm?
Yeah, your turn.
Can't exactly do much.
I'm gonna healing word you, not cure wounds. I know it's metagame.
Oh wait, I know exactly what I can do, and it's the best thing I can do.
Oh,
I be blasting.
He do be blasting.
I do be blasting. I'm fucking this guy up.
Which one? Because it went in the middle.
This guy.
The fake Brutus.
Fake Brutus. Okay. He's fucking dead.
Roll to hit the fake Brutus.
I hate it here.
Barely misses.
Oh,
I hate it here.
And then he just kind of scoffs at you and he goes,
"Uh oh, Disney might copy strike Tommy."
Oh well.
He just kind of goes, "Ha! What a joke!"
I'm gonna fucking strangle you. He doesn't even do the voice. He just says that.
No, it's fine. Pats him on the back a little bit and just says, "Don't worry, we all have bad days."
Alright, so...
You did this to me, Mason.
Alright.
No.
Alright, so...
You did this to me.
Alright, so, next. That is the end of your turn, correct?
It's all I fucking can do.
F. Alright, so, next, it is going to be a fake Brutus. And he is going...
Wait.
Okay, I'm waiting.
No, that's not all I can do.
Oh, yeah, if you want, I can back up. The
wounds I just did was not using a warlock spell slot.
Oh, okay. I'll rewind. I will rewind. So now what do you want to do?
I'm hexing the fake man.
The fake Brutus?
Fake Brutus. Fake
man.
All right, what save do... and I can't make a save or anything for that?
Not a save, he's just hexed.
All right, he is hexed.
And I missed my Eldritch Blast, so I'm not gonna...
What stat is he gonna have disadvantage
on? Oh yeah, he's gonna have disadvantage on strength saves.
Cool. Okay.
So... Kari could do something about that.
Wait, is it saves or checks?
One second. Checks. It's not saves. That'd be weirdly broken for the first level spell.
It's strength check to try to get out of it, so...
Aha, got it.
Ooh. Yeah, so, right. so strength.
Okay, so does he have disadvantage on his attacks? Or no?
No, it's just his checks.
All right, so fake Brutus
a big bag of peanut butter
is going to... He's going to move up to Drell and he's going to say, I don't care what happens anymore, I want your head.
On reaction... Whatever he's hitting, my spirit's gonna jump in the way.
Okay.
That's a thing I can do. I think it's a thing I can do. I can command it with a bonus action or reaction. I'm gonna double check. If it's not a thing I can't do, I don't want that to happen. But if it can, that's what I want to happen. Spirits and combat shares my blah blah blah. Only action takes dodge unless I take the bonus action. Okay, so I can't use a reaction. It has to be a bonus action. Okay. Shit, I should have commanded it to protect.
Okay, so...
That's my bad.
That's fine. So he's going to try to hit you.
Go ahead.
Does a 15 hit?
That is my armor class.
Oh. Man. That's going to be 6 slashing damage.
I'm at 1.
Oof. All right.
One hit point's a hit point.
So he's going to hit you, and he's going to go. Not so tough, are you, aren't you? Or not so tough, are you? Or you're not so tough, are you? Yeah, okay.
I'm just staring at him.
Did he say that 3 times in canon?
No, that was me stumbling on my words.
You had to say it was once.
Okay, in canon, because I messed up, he said it 3 times, and he stumbled the first 2 times, because he's looking at Form of Dread.
Weakling.
He grimaces, and that's going to be the end of his turn. Next is going to be a fake Pari. Who is going to...
Not dead yet.
He is going to go up to... real Pari, mm-hmm. And he's going to try to hit you.
All right. He subtracts a 1d4 from any damage.
Okay, he rolled a nat 1 on the first attempt.
I don't hit.
He gets 23 to hit, but that damage is going to be minus 4, or 1d4 minus.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so net, that is going to do... 2 damage. 2 slashing damage
cool.
to you.
Cool.
Wow.
I'm still in very good shape.
Alright, so he hits you, and he's like, fake! His voice sounds kind of squeaky because he's tiny. Fake, meet your maker. And he just, like, scratches.
I can barely see him because I'm big. It's like he pricked me in the leg. I'm like, huh?
You feel like a splinter.
Yeah. I was like, huh? Did I step on the wood wrong?
5'11" versus 6 feet.
All right, so that's going to be the end of his turn. Now it is going to be the fake mayor's turn, who can't do anything, so that is the end of his turn. Now it is going to be a fake Jor-El's turn. And he is also...
Oh boy, I bet he'll hit.
He's going to try to hit Pari. Wow, he rolls a 23.
Cool.
Yeah. What the fuck?
Pari has a trillion health, as we can tell by fake Pari.
All right. He eight slashing damage.
Eight. Oh. I'm still doing relatively well. He says takes 8 damage. Oh god.
Takes 8 damage. Oh fuck.
To be fair, 8 is 1/5 of my max health.
Oh, them moving up to you is just ruined my plan.
Okay, so. That's going to be the end of fake Jarrell's turn. Jafar is unconscious. He's making a death save. He succeeds. Next is
Jafar.
Yeah, hooray for Jafar. Next is going to be Brutus, who is going to try to run up to... let me just reveal that area. Give me a second.
There's just been a mom watching this the entire time.
Basically, yeah. She's just kind of... She's terrified. The son is trying to comfort her.
How much of the house is on fire? Mind me asking. Considering I am the fireman and this is all wood.
Surprisingly, not that bad.
Okay.
Actually, Burning Hands does light flammable things on fire.
So. Yeah. So I
cast that in the beginning.
You cast that in the beginning?
Oh, no.
Oh, actually? Wait a second.
Yeah.
I'm going to do my turn so I can see if I hit with the fire going.
Okay, actually...
That was not a serious joke.
Fuck. I'm going to say that... Fuck. At this point,
This area would definitely be on fire at this point.
At this point, I would say there's some... smoke in the room. Everyone roll a con save.
Con save? 20.
And I want food.
This is going to be cringe.
Cool.
15. Oh. Oh no.
Okay. Roll a anyone who failed, which is DC 10. Cool. Roll a 1d4 of damage from inhaling the smoke.
4. Cool. I'm dead.
You're unconscious.
Unconscious. Not dead.
Unconscious.
You're unconscious. You're unconscious.
You're unconscious. Okay. All right. So let's.
I have to, my spirit catches you.
Also, I should mention that I am also rolling for the NPCs who are inside. So let me start doing that.
And do that quickly.
One success. Yeah. 1, 2 success.
Wait, what? How big was the AoE? I'm not in it, right?
The entire house, yeah. Just the house.
It's the inside, yeah. You can see a lot of smoke coming out.
Okay. Fake Pari goes unconscious due to the smoke.
Finally.
We didn't even get to beat him.
He just collapses, and he stares down the real Pari, and as he turns back into a changeling, as he goes unconscious, same thing happened to Walker, he goes, So he's
down. I think they're just the bot again.
Yeah. Eye roll. Fake eye roll. He succeeds. Fake Jafar. Fake Jafar succeeds. Fake Brutus succeeds. And yeah, so the fire is starting to spread a bit, and there's enough smoke in the house just to cause some potential breathing issues. Okay, so I'm just trying to remember whose turn it was. Where was I in the turn order? I was on Brutus. Okay, so what Brutus is going to try to do is he's going to attempt to grapple Zelroth to prevent him from escaping. So they're going to roll off for strength. Or athletics roll off. So that's going to be... This is interesting. This is going to be... this one's 18. Oh, damn. So he's going to try to grapple him. But he fails at managing to grapple this guy. So he is still probably going to be able to escape very soon. Next, after Brutus, Park, it is your turn.
Okay, so I'm going to run in. I'm going to go 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Can I see this guy?
I'm going to say you can... Because of the smoke, I'd say roll a perception check. Not a disadvantage, a straight roll. To see if you can see him because of the smoke that's been gathering in the house from the fire that Iroll started at the start of the battle. Perception. Or what is your passive perception, if you don't mind me asking?
14.
Oh, yeah. You would be able to see him with that roll.
I'm going to cast Chaos Bolt at Fake Brutus.
Okay. All right. So roll to hit, or is that a DC save for me?
That's a roll to hit.
Okay. Please roll to hit.
I can't heal Drell, or else I would do that.
Okay.
18.
Yes, that's going to hit. Roll for damage.
Yo.
So it's... Four or three, so I get to choose the elemental type. Four or three, it's force or fire, so I'm going to do force. So it's...
How much damage total?
It's 7 force and 6. So 13.
Okay. He looks hurt, but he hasn't really been hit much at all this fight.
I'm going to burn a second, first level spell slot with my bonus action to get 2 sorcery points back.
Okay, you do that. And is that going to be your turn?
Yes.
Okay. Teeny, what do you want to do?
Help.
Please, Teeny. That is the plan. Well,
I'm currently surrounded.
I should mention that both, I should mention that Pari and Lockhart
are unconscious, and their changeling forms have, or actually, Pari is a doppelganger. Fake Lockhart is a changeling. For those in the area, or for those who are relatively close, you can see their forms dissipate as they go unconscious.
Get now, Fake Rail. He's been hit the least. Get him. Get him. Kick him. Kick him.
This one, yeah.
Yeah.
No, this.
No, 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 fake, no. Fake Rail's about
fake
to die. Other Fake Rail.
Okay, Mason.
Kidding. That is way too confusing. Jor-El.
I've been confused the entire fight. Actually, that's a lie. I know exactly what's happening, but I felt like saying I was confused. Okay, roll the hit, please.
All right.
If you're trying to hit him.
I ask him if he likes knives.
No. He says no.
Oh, I see. Too bad.
I should move myself here.
It's not really a knife, but this one does more damage.
Yeah, that's going to hit him.
What is your modifier?
For attack?
Yeah, for the attack, because you might not even need to roll for damage.
Dex.
Yeah, what's your dex modifier?
Oh, 7.
Or it's plus, I mean how much damage
five,
you do.
Five.
Yeah, so, okay, so you don't even have to roll for damage, you still can if you want, but, Fake Jor-El goes unconscious, and he goes from looking like a changeling to looking like a moderately different looking changeling, and he goes unconscious. And, do you want to do anything else with your turn?
I don't even know what Jor-El's true form.
Let's see.
I'm literally in it.
I do my.
Yeah, he's been. He revealed it.
Movements.
A little bit ago.
No, it doesn't look like I did my full movement.
You could go over him, yeah. Like I don't think.
If you want to go over, that would be a difficult terrain if you want to go over him. So
I have halfling nimbleness.
Oh, so then that's not going to take effect. Please move where you want to move.
I believe that's the rest of my movement.
Yep. And is that going to be the end of your turn?
Yeah, I can't prepare anything, yeah.
Okay, so that's going to be the end of your turn. Next, it's going to be Mason, or Iroh.
All right, so I am going to Healing Word, Jor-El. Back up. So that is. Sorry. Again. So yeah, I'm healing wording. Yep. Back up. So Jor-El's back with 6.
All right.
I'm stabbing this man.
So
yeah.
All right. So Jor-El is no longer unconscious.
Yep. And then I'm using as a level spell bonus action. I am going to go like right here, and I'm going to. Would I be able to produce flame at him from here?
You are 10 feet away from him, or like, are you doing it with your?
No. I want to make sure I don't hit Jor-El.
Jor-El is right in front of you.
Produce flame.
Just like he's in your way.
I'm still getting up.
Yeah. He's not going to
so
be
you
able
can shoot
to
shoot over me.
Actually, I would say that you were you're still getting up. I'm going to say that he does not get up until you would be able to hit him.
Okay, so I'm going to produce flame at Brutus, but as I'm doing that, I'm saying to my spirit protect, cuz I can give it like verbal commands like that. And if something's going to go and, like, hit, what's it called? If this is going to swing at Jor-El again, it's going to react immediately and take the brunt of the damage.
Right.
Okay.
So also, when I was knocked down, I was knocked out of Form of Dread, so now I'm just regular as Jor-El.
All right.
So I'm producing Flame at him, which is this. 15?
15 on Fake Brutus?
Yeah.
That's going to miss.
Alright, whatever. And I'm just going to use my movement to go like right here.
Where are you going?
I'm hopping on the table.
Okay.
To see the rest of the room that I haven't seen. Like, I've perceived it, but I want to get a clear look of what's going on.
All right. Have you rolled a perception check?
I have 20 passive perception.
Yeah, you would 20. See this. So, you would see this. So, you look, and you see Brutus failing to grab onto Zelroth, but Zelroth looks like he's lost something, and he's looking at Jafar.
Okay. So, so I'm just going to relay that to everyone and just be like, the guy with who's very obviously evil based on how he's dressed, I can't believe he'd go out in public like this, is making a break for it.
All right. Is that
That's the end of my turn.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, end of your turn. Now that is going to be Malcolm.
What do you want to do?
How is fake Brutus looking?
Still pretty decent.
All right, Jarell's just so incredibly pissed at him.
I should mention that.
I'm gonna look at him and I'm gonna say, at least I can face myself in my true form. Can you say the same?
It won't matter when you're on the ground.
I'm just gonna yell from my spirit. Just say, I can. Like, what are you talking about? I'm going to.
He looks like he's got. He looks like someone who's mad. Like, who's insane.
Alright.
Who's lost reason?
Backing up. Blasting.
Is that going to provoke an opportunity attack?
Does it do so diagonally?
Diagonal is the way we've established this.
Yes.
Alright.
Can move diagonal.
So he's gonna try He's gonna try to hit you.
Hey, guess what?
He's gonna take the hit for him.
My spirit jumped in front.
Alright, so he jumps in front, your spirit takes that is a hit. Or that's the dirty 21. Your spirit will take 6 slashing damage.
Spirit's looking fine.
Yeah. So he takes 6 slashing damage. Yeah. Is that gonna be
the way I'm gonna flavor that is that like as you cut it, because it's just like a nature spirit that just goes away when I can dispel it or like when it's like basically out of time. Like it's like you cut through like the fiery like brindles and they're just like so kind of slowly like reforming a little bit, but not as strong as before. Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm gonna say can't even fucking hit a bleeding man.
Alright, let's play.
Go and call me weak.
Let's play this.
I'm gonna spit at him too.
Someone get some music.
Spitting blood at him.
Ooh.
Epic music. I like this song. Anyway.
I don't feel all epic.
It's a great song.
Well, it is a great song, but I'm not sure if this is... Well, yeah, I'll roll with it. Is that the end of your turn?
Can't do anything else. Spitting blood at him.
All right, you spit blood at him. It hits him in the face, and he gives you a death stare.
Come hit me, big boy.
He growls at you. And, that's going to be the end of your turn. Next, it is... Oh, yes, it's going to be fake Bruce.
Actually, I'm going to back up a little bit more.
Okay. So, at this point, fake Brutus looks towards the exit, but he's still intensely looking at the guy who spat blood in his face. So, he is going to... One, two,
three. He's also going to eat a flame seed.
He is going to eat
with a...
He's going to eat the flame seed. But yeah. He is going to try to hit.
I'm gonna roll that.
Please roll that. But yeah, he's taking that.
Oh, I'm so weak, but why am I such a priority for you, huh?
Fuck, man.
Yeah, that's not going to hit him.
Mommy, is the token for Brutus a Fire Emblem guy?
Yes.
Yes.
Which guy is it?
He's just a random... he's a random-ass dude. He's just, like, a bandit captain.
Wait, did Pari move after I did? That's supposed to be the normal order.
I'm sorry. You can go next. I'm sorry about that.
All right.
Yeah, because that changes a whole lot. Like, I think we have to, like, kind of retcon that whole situation.
I'm sorry.
Just figure something out.
Put everyone back. Put everyone back. Jarrell's still on his feet. Like, Jarrell's back on his feet. Brutus hasn't made the attack yet.
He has not made.
Brutus goes right here. Jarrell goes right here.
Yeah. And I haven't taken my turn yet.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry about that. Rewind two people. Perry, what are you doing?
Mm-hmm. So.
Spit blood in his face, though.
Yes.
Let's see.
I'm going to.
So, I think IRL seems like. It seems like Teeny's got him covered. So I'm going to go.
Step on him.
How do I even move this? Like 5?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's like 10.
Another. fancy
15.
Feet.
20. And 25.
Yeah. So.
So I'm going to go right up to Big Brutus and say, hey, you're getting a little cocky there. I'm going to attempt to hit him.
Yes.
Thanks, big guy.
All right. So, try to sword. Also, I'm sorry. Wait, I'm sorry about that. There's a
lot
of stuff.
It's fine. It's fine.
All right. Please roll dice.
So, and it's with Booming Blade for reference.
Nice.
12 doesn't hit, I'm assuming.
That's going to miss him, unfortunately.
It's fine. And let me just check if something is a bonus action or an action. It's a bonus action. Ooh. I'm going to look at Brutus and say...
Or fake Brutus, but yeah.
If you like fighting so much, how about you take on someone... or how about you punch above your weight a little? And I'm casting Compelled Duel on him.
Ooh.
All right.
Nice.
Wisdom,
nice.
And that is a wisdom saving throw, correct?
Yes, it is.
If I'm so weak, then
he rolls.
You got a bigger target over there, buddy.
He rolls. An 8, so he fails.
All right. So now, what is this? For the duration, it has disadvantage on attack rolls against characters other than you.
Okay.
Nice. And it makes a wisdom save at the end of each of its turns.
Okay. So, is that the end of your turn?
That is all I can do.
Okay. So that happens. Now rewind the clock. Now it is Malcolm's turn. I'm not sure. Yeah, you can redo that turn. I would say.
I'm still not going to damage him because that ends the spell. So I'm just going to back up and be like, come on, man.
Oh, yeah. Is he still hexed at this point, or is the hex over at this point?
No, hex is just there.
Hex stays.
It's still there. I'm just
Wait.
I'm back.
Other people can.
IRL.
If a creature friendly to you. Oh, never mind.
Okay.
Wait.
No, I'm just making
up. Fake roll. You can finish fake roll off.
So I'm backing up next to IRL, but still gonna take a shot at evil man over there.
Gotcha.
All right. Roll to hit him.
I'm blasting this motherfucker.
And then I started blasting. Okay.
Watch this. It's not gonna hit.
Yeah, that's not gonna hit.
Cool. Yep. I'm not allowed
classic.
To do anything.
Man.
Classic.
Yes. And
the dice said Malcolm will do nothing.
Also,
I said Mason gets.
I also forgot to ask. Did this guy go?
No,
he did not.
You said that he.
He was looking at Jafar.
Yeah.
He
Jafar,
because apparently he lost something.
What he did with Jafar is he just. Basically, what he does during his action, he also provokes an opportunity attack from Brutus. Brutus hits him for...
Wait, no, it's at disadvantage. Because of compelled duel.
No.
This is the real Brutus.
Oh, real Brutus. My bad.
All right. So I'm just gonna make this fast. So real Brutus is going to do 10 slashing damage to this guy, and he's gonna go ah, and he's going to with his action. He's going to grab a shiny-looking red object off of Jafar, and that's his turn. And now we go back to
after Malcolm's turn. Okay, everything's back to normal, by the way, at this point. I'm just making sure. Sorry about that. There's just a lot of stuff for me to keep track of, and I'm still getting used to that.
Now, it's going to be Fake Brutus, and Fake Brutus is going to try to attack Vig. And he's going to miss.
And I look over to Irel and I'm like, thanks for the save back there.
Oh, nope. No problem, friend.
And then that's going to be the end of Fake Brutus's turn. So now it is going to be Fake Irel. No, Irel already went earlier.
Also, when he misses, I say, dumbass.
Yeah, I believe Irel did fake. Holy shit. Fake Irel did go already, actually. I remember that.
All right. So next in the turn order, he's not going to do anything. It's going to be... Fake Jarell is down. It's going to... Jafar is making another death saving throw.
Uh-oh.
He succeeds again.
Good for him.
All right. So Jafar succeeds. That's the end of his turn. Brutus is going to try to grapple this guy again.
Real Brutus.
Yeah, real Brutus. Brutus. So real Brutus, real Brutus rolled a 21.
Real Brutus.
And the guy rolls a 26. So he is not grappled.
Nice. So, oh wait, no, not nice.
Pog champion.
Unpog champion, because he didn't grapple again. So he fails at grappling, and that's going to be the end of his turn. Next is going to be finally Park again.
Park. Okay, so first off, I'm going to firebolt Fake Brutus.
Okay, roll hit.
Actually, no, can I Mind Sliver instead?
Yes, you can.
Okay, so int 16.
That was cocked. Yeah. He fails.
Cool. So 1d6. And then 1d4 from the next saving throw.
He is no longer under the effects of compelled duel.
Okay.
So, wait, why?
Because he took damage from someone other than me.
Okay. So he
Papari's next turn is before his. So
yeah.
Yes.
I'm fine.
And I'm also big and in the way.
Yes. Yeah, he's not gonna be able to get to
I'm gonna not this way.
What else are you going to do?
I'm going to quicken a chaos bolt and hurl it at the evil guy.
Roll the hit.
I really hope this works. Because that's my last sorcery point. Chaos bolt.
Okay. That's gonna unfortunately that's gonna miss.
And then I'm gonna move back.
We're just not allowed to roll one.
Well, we tried. We haven't even have we even touched Fake Jarell?
No.
Or Jafar?
No. Oh no, no, wait. I forgot to mention Fake Jafar. He's doing stuff after you.
Great. Cool.
And is that the end of your turn?
Yeah.
All right. So Fake Jafar is going to assess the situation, and he is going to dash over to Brutus, and he is going to try to grapple him. So he rolls that, and that's a tie, so I have to do something. What the fuck? Okay, he tries to grapple Brutus, but it does not work. And that's going to be his action. Top of the order again. Teeny, what do you want to do?
Tyler.
I'm gonna stab the man's.
The other man's. You mean? Fakril. You mean Fakril? Fakril. This guy.
Yeah.
All right. Roll the hit, please.
Man, I am playing cleanup crew. Okay.
Yeah, that's gonna hit. Roll for damage.
Awesome. I guess reroll for piercer.
Yeah. Reroll. Yeah, he is barely standing at this point. He looks about ready to collapse. Is that going to be your action?
Yes, and I'm just gonna move to this side of him.
Okay, I don't think that's going to... you're going to bonus action disengage to do that, right?
Wait, who is he getting up?
How is this Iroh still standing?
He's barely, like... He is barely standing.
He ate a full burning hands damage. He ate... What's it called?
I did say he was not a... He did not appear to be a changeling. He appears to be something a bit...
Okay.
More difficult. But yeah, if you bonus action disengage and want to move there, he's not going to be able to hit you. Tyler, if you want to still do that.
Yeah. Let's see, where am I going?
Or what do you want to do now with that? Also, Mason, please prepare your turn.
Yep.
After...
I'm just going to go over here. Okay. Yeah.
All right, yeah, you don't provoke an opportunity attack. That's the end of your turn. Now it is the real Iron's turn.
Okay.
Stand up.
Yep, I'm going to bonus healing word Jafar.
Okay.
So that he doesn't have to keep making death saves, and he can get back in those.
Okay. Please roll for
Yep, so...
Jafar gains back. 8, and he is off the ground.
Okay, and then
I should mention that fake Iroh is about to collapse. But
yeah.
Not sure if that impacts your decision or not. Also,
this is like a hallway, yeah? This is a hallway?
Yes.
Okay.
You can go through there if you want.
Yeah. So I'm gonna... Am I out of line of sight from here?
I would say so, yes.
Okay.
But I should mention that Fake Jafar is in front of him, so it's...
Oh, that's fine.
Yeah.
Because... Yeah, that's fine.
Oh, yeah. I forgot to make him not unconscious. Okay. Yes?
Okay. I'm going to throw a produce flame at Fake Jafar.
Fake Jafar? Okay. Roll to hit, please. Yep. Hits. 18. Roll for damage.
Fucking kidding me.
Chill. I fucking hate this. Come on. Thank you, Vincent.
Very cool.
Alright. So, is there anything else you'd like to do?
No. That's all I can
what
do.
Okay. So he
is... Oh wait. Yeah, there's something else I'd like to do.
What is it you would like to do?
I would like to flame seed at this guy, so I'm gonna have to make a melee spell attack.
Fake Jafar again. Okay, please roll.
Yeah,
that's gonna hit him. Please roll for damage.
So that's 8 more fire damage.
He is looking very bad.
Yeah, and it's like it just produced like a seed of like literally like a baseball of fire and threw it at him.
Yeah,
baseball, not a football.
Well, a round seed.
All right. So you do that. Yep. It hits Fake Jafar, He does not look good at all. So, that's what I am going to assume. The end of your turn. Now it is Pari's turn.
All right. So I'm going to see. We're going to see that, like, literally everyone is here. And I'm just going to assume they got Brutus covered.
Yeah, so I'm going to go. Please go for
five,
him.
Oh, wait. Actually.
It's fine.
I'm sorry. Please go back. I messed up the... I'm sorry. You were tied with him. He beat you in the initiative. I am sorry about that. So...
That's fine.
Okay. So... Zelroth is going to try to run away, but he's kind of, I'm going to say that, like, as you kind of got him up with the healing word, he was still kind of, you know, making sure he could get the orb off Jafar. So instead of an attack, he's trying to take the orb back. So we'll see what happens. With that. Let's see. So that's going to be. That is cocked. That is also cocked. Oh, wow. So, Jafar snatches the orb back from Zelroth. As he tries to run away. And he notices that. He stops right here, and he's going to be taking an opportunity attack from Brutus. And he's going to take a hit. And that is going to be 11 slashing damage. He's looking terrible. And he grimaces, he just is pissed at Jafar. Now it's Pari's turn.
Alright,
Fuck him up.
This is an interesting position.
Just run in and hit fake Jafar.
Fuck him up.
When I'm enlarged, do my weapons have reach?
No, that'd be really cool.
Sure. Right.
You could probably just push regular Jafar out of the way.
That's what I'm going to. That's what I think. So 5, 10, 15, 20. I'm going to ask Jafar to just move. Out of the way.
He'll move.
He should comply to the giant knight.
He's gonna comply.
So like 25.
You're not going. 30. Yeah.
Actually, weird because of how the sizing works, but I'm actually, like at the edge of this doorway, just straight through it.
Yeah. So you're kind of peeking through. Okay.
And I am going to attack this dude.
Okay. Roll the hit.
And it's booming blade.
Oh.
He's not running.
Okay. Come on.
He's gonna
imagine rolling well.
That's going to miss, unfortunately.
Couldn't be.
Wait. Do I have anything I can do with my bonus action? Let me check.
Can you compel duel again, or spells?
I have a spell, but I'm just seeing. Shoot. Yeah, whatever. I'll compel duel him.
All right. And that is a wisdom saving throw.
DC 15.
Wow, he gets a nat 20.
Of course he does. I'm just not allowed to do anything.
I'm sorry. All right.
Welcome to the club.
Okay. That's going to be the end of your turn. So that is going to be...
One spell left.
Oh, shit. Yeah, this is crazy. So next after... So, fake Iroh, who is next, he's going to try to run away.
Hmm. Why? How is he still alive?
I don't know.
So, he's gonna move here.
Okay. I think, Teeny could get an opportunity attack.
She does. Yeah, you're gonna get an op... Actually, no, wait. Did you move away from him? Wait, wasn't he moved up. Yeah, so he's here.
That's fine.
Well, whatever. Oh wait, no, we left the mayor out there.
He has to take his actions to do that though.
Yeah. So it's going to be fake Iroh. That's gonna be his action. Now it is going to be Let's see. Next in the turn order, it is going to be Malcolm.
What?
Your turn.
Yeah, you're up.
Okie dokie. How's fucker here doing?
Not too good.
Bad even.
Pretty bad.
Do I blast him or do I stab him?
Blast him.
Yeah,
blast Eagle. Him.
You're too low. You shouldn't go in.
Yeah, I'm just gonna be like, hey, over here. Remember me?
He's just growling at you. He's like,
nah. Yeah, real mad now, aren't you? Weren't you having fun a couple minutes ago?
He looks like a mad dog. He just looks like he's kind of lost his mind. And he just wants to nothing more than to hit you since the compel duel wore off.
Yeah, sure you do. Sure you do. You gotta get your priorities straight, buddy. D20 plus 7. Fuck!
That's going to miss.
That was on purpose. That was a distracting shot.
Oh my god. I would feel bad if I hadn't rolled above a 10 for like the past 2 months.
Okay. So, I've siphoned
a glass.
No, Mason, now we're just all right. Mason, now we're just down at your level.
What the fuck has been this RNG this fight? It's been so dumb on both ends. Alright. Next. What else do you want to do, Malcolm?
I'm using that mist to like shoot a glass off the bar next to him and be like,
hey, that was looking
pretty weak. Why don't you go shoot that?
Yeah, he's staring at you. And yeah, I guess that's the end of your turn, correct?
Come and get it, shithead.
Okay, so that's going to be the end of your turn. Now it is going to be
the evil man. The evil man's up there.
Now it's Brutus's turn. He is going. It's evil Brutus's turn. So he is going to.
Oh no!
You get the opportunity attack from the spirit. 1, 2, 3. 4.
Okay. Yeah, he's gonna flaming seed him.
Oh what?
Roll to hit.
Why is he going after? Is he going on Jarrell again?
I mean,
he's going after. Jarrell's been taunting him.
I've been taunting him.
Yeah, you hit him. Yeah, that's okay.
Bye, Jarrell. I can't heal you.
I'm not plus eight, plus six, plus seven.
Don't you have a melee spell?
He looks like he's about to collapse.
I don't have Warcaster.
But with
I have a wand
with
my hand.
His sheer determination, he's going to try to hit Jarrell. He gets a 17.
Yeah.
7 damage.
Guess what? I'm unconscious again.
X. Let's go.
So he knocks you out, and he just kind of laughs.
How's your boss over there doing?
And he goes, he just starts laughing maniacally.
Oh, this isn't good. Now I'm in the range.
Okay, yeah, as I go down, I'm just flipping him off.
Okay, so you do that. That's going to now be the end of his turn. So now it is going to be... Actually, the mayor is going to try to restrain fake Iroh.
What? He's sitting on top of the
ring.
He notices. Yep. So,
can the mayor bonk him or something?
He's going
like,
to try
throw
to.
Him with, you have a cane. There's a cane in the picture.
He's going to try to do something.
We're getting desperate.
I'm just clarifying here, Park. You don't have a touch spell on you that you can use.
Wait, shocking grasp?
I can't make spell opportunity attacks because I don't have Warcaster.
He does have the fake mayor was holding a cane. The real mayor picked it up. He's going to try to hit Iroh with his cane.
The fake Iroh with his cane.
Yeah, sorry. That's going to hit, and he's unconscious. The fake Iroh is unconscious. So wow. the mayor knocks him with his cane. Barely does enough.
That was funny.
He literally had 1 HP left.
Thank you, Mayor Knickerbocker.
So the mayor sees fake Iroh and he's just kind of like, woo! And he hits him with his cane and he's unconscious. So that's he does that. I'm sorry.
He jumps a little bit. He doesn't even intentionally hit him. The cane just goes wide and hits him.
So Mayor Knickerbocker is just kind of like, None of you guys can see this, but he's just in shock that he actually did something.
Wow, he did more than me.
And me, I don't think I've hit anything in the last 5 turns.
No, this has been the I roll wildfire spirit show.
Yeah. Okay, so
you have your time in the sun, Mason.
Okay, finally. Next, okay, I'm sorry that it's taking so long. There's so much shit for me to keep track. Next, now, after that guy, it is going to be. Oh yeah, it's actually going to be.
Should be close to Teeny, yeah, to the top.
It's close.
Lockhart, yeah, Lockhart.
It's Jafar's turn. It's almost Lockhart. So Jafar is going to.
He's gonna go up to fake Brutus and he's gonna be like, "Hey, that's a nice guy over there. I'm not letting you just knock him out and get away with it." So he's going to try and hit fake Brutus. Wow, holy shit. He rolls a nat 20. Are you kidding?
Of course he does.
Did he roll with advantage or anything?
No. He managed to roll a nat 20. I am not shitting you. And,
Hey, I'm stabbing here.
I'm not even, like... I wish I was joking. I am not joking. Yeah,
so I'm gonna end the combat. Next
he round. Knocks fake Brutus unconscious somehow.
Good.
So that's
beautiful. Yeah,
fake Brutus is unconscious. So that is going to be his turn. Now it is Brutus's turn. He's going to try to grapple this guy one more time.
Sorry, I hope you kill him.
He does not grapple him again. What the fuck? So,
of course he doesn't.
And that's going to be the end of Brutus's turn. Now it is Mark's turn.
Lockhart.
Get him.
I'm dying inside. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30.
I should.
I'm going to cast Chaos Bolt on Big Jafar.
Okay, roll the hit.
It's gonna miss.
No, that's gonna hit him.
Yo.
Roll for damage.
Okay, I rolled a 1 or a 6. 1 is acid, 6 is poison. So I'm gonna do acid to fake Jafar.
Is that?
And overall, it is 7 plus 5, which is
12. Fake Jafar goes unconscious.
Good. Finally. And then. As my action, I'm just going to go next to Pari.
Okay. Is that going to be the end of your turn?
Let me see if I have any bonus action stuff. I don't think I do.
Okay.
I'm out of points.
It is Teeny's turn, by the way.
Yeah. I'm going to end the fight next turn.
Okay.
I'm out of points and stuff.
Can you help me out, buddy?
Yeah, I was like, do I help you up or do I like try and dash over?
Yeah, if you want, you can.
Iroh's got it. Iroh's got it.
I mean, you can use his action to stabilize him so he doesn't.
I will go ahead
saying,
and do that.
I was saying, help me up to Iroh.
I am going to attempt to stabilize this man.
No. Iroh has me.
Okay.
What?
Yeah.
I mean, I can. I'm gonna end the fight. How's the evil man looking? No, but I can't cast a level spell.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
I'll be fine.
How's the evil man looking?
He still has a little bit of kick left in him.
Shoot him, don't worry about me.
Okay.
Alright. So, shoot the man. That's what I'm getting out of this?
I'm not sure how feasible it's going to be to hit him with Pari in the way.
Yeah, so stabilize him.
Because Pari is pretty big and he's kind of peeking through.
Lockhart's right there, yeah. It's a tough shot.
It's a tough shot. So yeah, I would say if you want to hit him, it would be with disadvantage. Because it's a very difficult shot to make, given the size.
It's your call, man.
Yeah, it's up to you.
I should say,
you would be rolling with disadvantage unless someone wants to do anything.
I can
about
cancel
that.
Disadvantage with my reaction.
So he's going to do that. So you would have a straight roll if you go for that. What do you want to do, Tyler?
Do it.
Yeah, that's what I'm going
to
do.
All right, roll to hit.
If it hits, it's sneak attack.
Roll to hit.
helpful. Come on.
So.
It's regular roll, regular roll.
Alright.
Roll two hits.
The ability to cancel disadvantage is so stupid.
Alright. That's gonna miss, unfortunately.
Okay.
Never gonna win this fight. Never gonna win
this.
I'm gonna roll one on a death save.
Now, okay. Alright, next it's Iroh.
Alright, a healing word and back up.
Let's see. Okay.
Alright, roll to heal him.
Okay, good.
Roll to heal. So he doesn't have to make a death saving throw.
Yep. So he's back again.
Tommy kills.
So Iroh's gonna he's running right up, and it's prepping a primal savagery, and he's gonna try to punch him right in his stupid fucking face.
You are on top.
I will gladly stuff my boot onto fake Jafar's face.
Okay. So how much? Yeah. You would make it. So roll to hit if you want to do that to him. Please do that.
Come on.
Yo.
Yeah, 20.
Holy shit. Roll for damage.
9. Wow. Acid. That's still.
He is barely standing.
Yeah, so I'm just like running up. I'm running up, and like my fist is like completely like animalistic. And I just say like right before I just yo, but it sounds like the raging wildfire to try to get his attention away from Brutus. And as he looks at me, it's just like a cold cock, like I'm trying to separate his jaw.
All right. So you do that. He's taking a number. And is that going to be the end of your turn?
And my wildfire spirit.
Oh shit!
Is that not? Oh, sorry. Never mind.
I don't know. Do you have enough room to get him over there?
Didn't you use your action though?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. I can't. I can't. Healing word.
So.
Yeah.
So, as a last ditch effort, he is going to. Or no, he's going to. Let's see.
If he runs away, he can eat the Shillelagh lead opportunity attack.
There are three opportunity attacks waiting for him.
And the good Brutus.
Oh, wait, I have a knife. I could do opportunity attacks, but it would do, like, 2 damage.
So,
he's going to... Wait, can he even use
his... I got
his...
a knife.
Can he even use his action to disengage? Fuck.
He do gotta use his action.
Yeah. So he's disengage going... from home. Oh, he can only disengage from one person, huh?
Disengage from whom?
So he's gonna.
No,
that's not how it works.
Disengages on everyone.
He's going to. Seeing he has no chance of retrieving the orb, he runs away.
Yeah, fuck off.
So
it's my turn, isn't it?
Yeah, but combat is over at this point. He ran
what?
Away.
Wait,
can I not just? He
has 30 all, yeah, we just start running just after him.
Get inside the fucking building.
Then I'm gonna firebolt him. If combat's over, I'm just gonna start spamming
to 30 feet and hit him.
Yeah, you can. Do you want to try to catch him as he's running? If you try to chase him, so at this point,
I'm gonna blast him.
Okay, combat is over. But if you want 17. To do something, that's gonna miss.
Fuck.
Pari, are you gonna try to dash after him?
Yeah, I'm just gonna run after him.
Can I try and shoot him again?
So, yeah.
Yeah, you have the same movement as him. So do you want to chase after him?
Yes, we're going to keep running after him.
Tom, the fight's not over. We're chasing after him.
All right.
Yeah.
So,
can I shoot him?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah.
Imagine being allowed to hit.
What the
fuck? No, but I like you bet your ass that Iroh's running after him.
Everyone
shooting fire bolts at him just like pew pew.
Everyone take a shot. Combat's still going. I can't really express it on the map. He gets about 30 feet away. If you people want to do anything to him.
Yeah, Firebolt has 120 feet range.
I have 30 feet movement.
Okay, that's going to miss.
Malcolm hit a 19 with an Eldritch Blast.
Yeah, that's going to hit him. Roll for damage on.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
On Zul'Roth. Yes, sir. Yes. At this point, this is just like he's trying to. Do a last ditch effort.
He's just dodging all of our stuff.
We are not letting him.
10 plus 5, 11.
Please.
That, or actually,
Oh shit.
Tommy, you said he was low on the last
hit. He's going to use his reaction to cast shield.
What? He had that the whole
time? Tommy, he has not shown that he's been a spellcaster this entire time.
Yeah, okay, you get him. You get him.
Tommy.
Don't do
that.
I had him as a... He was a paladin. I'm sorry, I should have expressed that better.
Paladins don't get shield.
Paladins don't get shield.
Wait, he doesn't?
No, they get Shield of Faith, not Shield.
Oh, yeah, Shield of Faith,
Shield of Faith just adds to AC.
Oh my god, I am so sorry. I was thinking of something else. Sorry.
Did that 11 knock him out?
Yes, it did. How do you want to do this? I'm sorry.
Are you killing him?
No, like, do you want to kill him? Do you want to knock him out?
I'm not. It's gonna be non-lethal. Like, okay. I'm physically holding myself back.
Okay, so...
And I'm as everyone's trying to hit him, I just slowly walk between everyone, just, like, very weakly throw my hand up blast it.
So bad.
And then I walk over, I step on his back, I lean down, and I say, fuck you.
I'm still huge, and I'm gonna say, Jared, I'll just move off for a sec, and I'm gonna bring out rope and start tying him up.
Also, I'm sorry. I misread Shield of Faith is actual shield. That's my bad. Sorry. Anyways, you get him, and he collapses on the ground.
Yeah, I'm tying him up.
All right. Yeah. So, you want to tie everyone up at this point?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're putting him in the moonbeam pile.
Okay. So I should mention that
Arya, let the spell go.
I should mention that as he goes unconscious, he is also a changeling.
Whoa. Of course he is. Of course he is.
Incredible.
No one would have ever expected that.
What a shocker. What a surprise.
Okay, so you round them all up. You have a total of 2 doppelgangers. And 5 changelings. And you've gathered also what you got when combat is over, you guys gonna try to put out the flames that happened as a result of
I'm just
walking through the flames. I don't even
Iroh has fire resistance. Like,
I'm just gonna leave the building.
Alright,
my spirit is going to go up and I'm gonna
is there a mother and child?
Is going to say leave with us.
Yeah. So they're gonna leave. They're gonna leave with the fire spirit.
Anyone else in the building?
Yeah. Are you guys just gonna drag out all the changelings at this point?
Yeah.
I'm checking on the mayor. No, the fake mayor.
No, we want to question them.
Are you going to gather everyone?
Yeah, and I'm gonna check if there's anyone upstairs.
Okay. Go upstairs. You look around, there's a young boy just kind of like sitting there.
Hey, the house is on fire.
Oh, are the scary people gone?
Yeah.
Okay, take me
with you. Took them all out.
Okay, so he's gonna like kind of hold onto your hand and you can take him out of there.
His hand and drag him. Well, not drag him, but like pull him.
I know.
Guide him out, yeah.
So, down the stairs, just boom, 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 boom.
Yeah.
Bonked his noggin.
I don't have a icon for him, so this is just him.
Okay, and then I leave.
Yeah.
Sorry about the house.
It's
I think I'm gonna like tap out for now because I'm feeling feverish.
Yeah, we should start.
Yeah, no, yeah. Right. So yeah. Yeah, no, it's fine. Thanks. At this point, I can say the session is over at this point if you feel like you need to.
Yes.
Cool. Yeah, we're all outside the house and the changelings are in the moonbeam pile.
Yes.
I'm gonna down an ibuprofen and crash probably.
Yeah. I hope
you feel better.
Peace.
Feel better.
All right. Okay. Yeah, that's the end of session. It was like I was trying. More will be revealed next session about exactly why stuff happened that way. Sorry about the ending. I legitimately misread his spell list. So,
Yeah. Oh, that's a good sheet. I'm sorry.
I yelled at you there.
No, it's fine. That was just me, like, double checking, and I was like, oh, shit, I fucked up. That's my bad.
Yeah, I would just say, like, even though, like, I'm also, like, new DM and everything, I think just the amount of NPCs that were in combat.
Yeah, there were too many.
Yeah, no, but I'm saying, like, even that.
Half the combat was a fight that didn't even involve us.
Yeah. That was my fault.
Yeah.
I'm going to end this.